There has been no activity by the Cult of Diablos. The Midgar Kingdom has been quiet since the incident at the Bushin Festival. The smaller sects are at a standstill, and it seems the Fenrir sect appears to be immobilized by the confusion.
It is all going exactly to your plan, my lord.
Now we can set our sights forward and we can finally focus on our main efforts on the situation in the Orianna Kingdom.
We should note there is a troubling bit of news.
There's been a recent acceleration of funds flowing into the Lawless City.
Really?
That region doesn't belong to any nation, my lord. It's a giant slum where the evil, wealth, and the power of the world converge. Any tension that occurs in that region could have an immeasurable effect on the rest of society.
Although we would like to focus our efforts on accomplishing our plan, unfortunately I must suggest that we send out additional personnel.
I smell it. The Lawless City reeks of blood. A storm is brewing. A storm of blood. The Red Moon.
The tragedy of 1,000 years ago. That means the Lawless City will, if nothing's done, surrounding nations will experience catastrophic damage.
Silence, everyone! If that is an omen of the legendary Red Moon, we cannot merely sit here and gaze idly at the sky. We Seven Shadows
will... Let me handle the money. I mean this matter.
No! You intend to go there alone?
You object.
We understand that would be the surest method, my lord. However,
should the unthinkable happen to you, Lord Shadow, we would...
Fear not. The moon has merely turned red, that's all. Nothing more.
No more than a moon turned red. Faced with you, even the legendary Red Moon is stripped of its dignity.
Do you not find the moon to be beautiful and red?
It is because we have you, my lord, that we too are able to see its beauty.
We wish you the best of luck in battle.
Your will be done in all things.
I will analyze some dragon tears while you're away.
So no one knew that it was important. A harbinger of the revival of the Blood Queen. No one, that is,
but the Great Shadow.
Get these girls involved, and the legendary Red Moon comes to life in the blink of an eye. Seriously, their ad-libbing skills are totally worthy of an Academy Award. It's just a kind of reddish moon, no biggie.
So this is it.
Yeah. The Crimson Tower, ruled by the Blood Queen. She's the Queen of Vampires and one of the three rulers of the Lawless City.
A castle of vampires, huh? Look at that. Not even the corpse-raiding vultures dare to get near it. They think if they get too close, it's all over. They'll end up as hideous ghouls.
What, are you scared?
Don't be ridiculous. It's just a hangout for a bunch of shut-ins. With the power of Goldie...
You pathetic vermin aren't worthy to pass through this gate. The only ones authorized are servants or guests of the Blood Queen and powerful warriors. You two are neither of those things.
I get it, and you're right. As you said, we're not servants or guests.
We are powerful warriors here to hunt the Blood Queen.
I don't see what's so funny.
I thought I was a fool, which is why it's always so amusing to find someone more foolish than I am. You clowns make me laugh. Is this what happens to fools who dare challenge the Blood Queen? You see this? I lost my right arm, and now I am kept here as a pathetic watchdog on a leash.
So what? We're not amateurs like you and the other beasts that come here.
My power level is 4,317.5.
I was just like you once, just as confident, just as foolish. They called me the White Devil.
You're the White Devil? The wanted criminal with a huge bounty on his head?
But here, I'm nothing more than a lowly watchdog. Living apart idiots like you who don't know their place and refuse to learn is the only joy I have left in life!
Get ready. Bring it!
City is even more of a dump than I imagined.
Stop gawking. You
don't want to catch the attention of any weirdos.
Yes, ma'am. Hey.
What?
Aren't we going to that tower?
You are so... First, I'm going to the Dark Knight Association for a strategy meeting.
Dark Knight Association? Never saw any of those back home.
Because we have our own Knight Order. The Dark Knight Association is an unofficial organization that doesn't belong to any public institutions.
The summer of my last year of high school, I was on the road to becoming Eminence in Shadow when my journey came to an abrupt end. Or so it seemed. But one thing after another, this stuff turned into that. And that, I don't even know. This, and that were all like this, and it was kind of like this. And all of this happened, and here we are.
That's the match! I'm a try, not a loose, is down for the count! And the winner is... Claire Kagano!
My sister won the Wuxian Festival Championship. To celebrate, I used my connections with Gamma and got dressed up for a free... high-end fancy dinner at a Mitsugoshi restaurant, but...
I'm going to the Lawless City to exterminate vampires.
The tournament ended, and she headed right off to battle. I know she's my sister, but even I wonder how she can be so hot-blooded.
I brought you here with me out of consideration for your future, you know.
My future?
If you stay behind me and do everything I say, I'll pry open a spot for you in Midgar's Knight Order after you graduate.
Okay. So, she's trying to bulk up my resume to make me a government employee. Come to think of it, I haven't really considered what I'll do after I graduate. Claire will inherit the estate out in the boondocks, so I think they'll stick me in some kind of job somewhere. As long as I can do what I want to do, I don't really care what kind of job I end up with.
And what is it that you want to do?
It's secret. I make it a point not to tell anyone the things that really matter to me.
You're just making that up. Stop trying to cover up the fact that you just haven't thought about it.
Why do you assume that? Whatever, it's fine.
No, it's not.
Hmm?
It's not fine.
There, come take a look, my beautiful young lady. I just got a new stock of first-rate pets.
You mean me?
Yes, I mean you, the most beautiful young lady in the world.
Well, you have a good eye.
You know he's buttering you up, sis.
You be quiet.
But please, come look, miss. These lucky finds just came in this morning. This is today's hot item. The pet dark knight, little Colby. What do you say? He's quite the handsome specimen. Perfect for such a lovely lady.
He's all beat up. Can't you handle your products more carefully?
I guess he did get a little banged up in transit. All right, he's worth 30 million zenny, but I'll let you have him
he
for 20.
He looks kind of familiar.
A little steep.
Okay, I get it. I'll give you a special deal and throw in this little guy. Another fresh new catch, Q-Ball Quinton. Two pets for the low price of 40 million zenny? What do you say?
He's been sliced through the middle.
Okay. 37 million zenny. I can't go any lower than that.
Not interested.
I've seen him somewhere.
Drive a hard bargain. All right, I'll let you have him for 35 million.
I'm sorry, but I have all the pets that I need.
So you prefer younger pups. In that case, I think I'm expecting a shipment of a Dark Knight Academy student with...
I can't walk very well when you're dragging me. Like...
If I don't keep a hand on you, you'll get lost.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will.
No, I will not.
I know for a fact you will.
And I did. I just stepped out because I was bored at the inn. People watching seemed interesting.
Oops. Sorry.
And that is what we call karma.
Coming through. Sorry about that, kid.
You need to get home, little boy.
Thanks for your business.
It's always been a dog-eat-dog world. I can't believe I'm getting money just by taking a stroll. This city is heaven for me.
Now you've really done it, you little punk! How are you gonna make it up to us, huh?
I'm in a bad enough mood already!
I lost a bet! My dear sweet Marie turned me down, and it's all your fault! You rotten little...
So that's a ghoul. A vampire underling. I've heard they have, like, a lot of HP, but I guess around here, they're just everyone's punching bags. It really is a dog-eat-dog world. Just what I'd expect from the Lawless City. A town drenched in blood and slaughter.
Thank you.
way! This rancid thing was still alive?
A human who gets bit by a ghoul turns into a ghoul himself.
Apparently. That was only a rumor. When what actually happens is...
Oh, is that why? The Red Moon is stimulating all the magical energy in town. If I don't do anything, they'll just keep multiplying. What to do? Do I run away like a background character? Or maybe what happens in the Lawless City stays in the Lawless City, and I try the mysterious young man act. Anyway, since I do get to be in a zombie apocalypse, I think I'll let things get a little bit more out of hand before I...
Get down!
You are?
Mary. My name is Mary. The ancient vampire hunter.
Ancient.
Run if you value your life.
If you value your life, run.
The frenzy has begun.
The frenzy has begun.
The moon is red. We are out of time.
We're out of time. What is happening? What is this feeling? This thrill in my heart. This is...
Does he just never listen to me? I told him to be a good boy and wait here.
I'm saved.
Hey, have you seen a boy with black hair and black eyes?
No. No, I haven't.
Oh. Where did that idiot wander off to?
Huh? Ah!
We're gonna get laid!
Yeah.
The Academy will never find us here. They can't possibly expel us.
It was so worth risking our lives to come here.
Our summer may be almost over.
But our virginity's still as strong as ever, dear friend Skell.
Oh, yeah.
When will we ever become real adults, you think, huh?
Now, of course.
Into the splendor
of the glorious world of maturity.
Let's go.
What was that for?
You are way too excited. God, I hate that dirty old man. How long will this go on? What now? Another street fight? I'm trying to wallow in misery here.
Corrupt clergy. He's at least as dangerous as any of the rulers of this city.
No, doing? I'm getting out of this crazy messed up town. You'd break your contract? But who knows what they'll do if they find you? Thank you for my life, Shadow.
Try to escape if you so desire. If you're fortunate, you may even be successful in your attempt. Of course, the past is never so kind as to let anyone go.
Lady Yukime!
The vampires have set ghouls loose in the city!
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, little brother. If only I hadn't brought you to this horrible place.
Pardon, are you the woman going around asking about a boy with black hair and black eyes? Because I met one not long ago.
I've already found him. He's my brother. I found him just now.
That boy doesn't have black hair or black eyes. What? Who the hell are you? I met two men who matched the description.
Tell me!
I saw the first one when the moon was beginning to turn red. He was standing in front of a rampaging ghoul and smiling.
That's not him. My brother would scream in that situation. He would never smile.
I saw the second one a few minutes ago. He was a young dark knight with no noticeable features.
Where was he? Tell me now!
He was about to be taken away by the followers of the Blood Queen.
The Blood? They took him away? Where'd they go? The Crimson Tower?
Indeed, your brother is in the Crimson Tower, the Blood Queen's castle. The vampire's wish is to offer him a sacrifice to the Blood Queen.
Sacrifice?
To awaken Blood Queen Elizabeth from her thousand-year slumber. They require the blood of a living young man.
Wait, what's this about the Blood Queen being asleep?
They've kept that fact secret, biding their time, waiting 1,000 years for the night that would give the vampires tremendous power. The night the Red Moon would rise again.
It's true, the moon has seemed redder these last few days.
Of course, the Red Moon has an effect on the Sleeping Queen as well. And with the sacrifice of blood as the catalyst, she will surely...
But the point is, Cid is in the tower, right? And if they need the blood of the living, then he's still alive.
My target is the Blood Queen Elizabeth. To find her, I must go to the Crimson Tower.
Then we're heading in the same direction. Let's work together. Who are you?
Name is Mary. I am a vampire hunter.
My name is Claire.
It will be difficult to get in from the ground floor, but there is a way. Follow me.
Got it. I'm coming for you, Cid!
Are almost complete. Our takeover of the city is going as planned, however.
However?
We are meeting some unexpected resistance.
We know who's behind that, don't we? The fools who babble on with their nonsensical ideas that they're my equals. Yukime, the Spirit Fox, ruler of the White Tower. Juggernaut, the Tyrant, ruler of the Black Tower. Let them play their childish games. They will meet their end as soon as the Blood Queen has been revived.
Yes, my lord. There is one other thing.
What is it?
Someone's going around the city, killing ghouls.
Stop it!
Right to hell, She-Fox.
Oh, the Juggernaut. You truly are a thorn in my side. I insist that you cease opening your mouth and spewing your rancid breath.
You're the one who reeks, Animal Lady!
I do not care for pussy men!
Nothing changes. Someone. Somewhere. Maybe out there trying to spin a new tale. But I do not change. I only continue on my quest to become the Immanence in Shadow. Who are you?
Are you?
My name is Shadow. He who lurks to hunt in the shadows.
Killing was what gave my life meaning. It's what made me feel truly alive. I was standing at the top of this fight for survival, or so I thought. Until... now look at me. The ghouls are wreaking havoc all over town. I'll take anyone. I'll even take me. Just let me kill somebody! Stare at this, gruntlings! Is that really? That giant cleaver? That piercing glint in his eye, full of overwhelming savagery? It's the ruler of the Black Tower, Juggernaut the Tyrant! Nine Tails, a symbol of the highest ranking Therian Throop, ruler of the White Tower, Yukime the Spirit Fox! They're both major big shots, but no matter what I do, I'd still never beat them! Why did these two have to come over here onto my turf? Huh?
My name is Shadow. He who lurks in the shadows in order to hunt the shadows.
Shadow,
you know, the dawn of the armed militants who have taken the Midgar Royal Capital as their turf.
Oh, that's right. You're the boss of that gang that wiped the floor with those sooty priests, I remember. Whatever. That's none of my business. Catch you later, She-Fox. Next time, I'll kill you.
The moon is red. The frenzy has begun.
The frenzy? Are you referring to this current trouble with the ghouls?
You mean that Red Moon legend where they say three kingdoms fell when it was in the sky? Sounds good to me. It's about time those bats will finally start to give me a decent workout.
What is it with that man? Well, then I'll excuse myself. It seems you helped some of my girls in the Pleasure District, so let's remain on friendly terms, my dear Shadow.
The entire castle gate is an artifact. How did he break it down with a sword? The Tyrant. And his rival, the Spirit Fox. And they are both after the Blood Queen. Every one of them is a worthless monster. You've got to be kidding me. I wanted to slice up some humans, damn it. That guy. Who is he? I don't sense any power from him at all. That means he's weaker than me.
That settles it, you weakling! You're my prey!
Frenzy has begun. We're out of time.
What in the actual...
If this was the general technology of the time, then we must conclude that the cult's level of technology was extraordinary. I see here that the source of their power was found in the demon. That much I get. But where could they have possibly found the knowledge necessary to harness that kind of power?
I told you not to touch things willy-nilly.
How was I supposed to know it would become a slide?
Anyway, now we have successfully made it inside the tower. I can't believe that passage would turn into a slide and connect everything like this.
What am I to do with this? I'm supposed to eliminate all witnesses, but now... I don't think I can. I have absolutely no desire to fight you, Miss Claire.
How is it you know who I am?
You're the winner of the recent Bushin Festival, Miss Claire Kagano, are you not?
She doesn't appear to me to be a vampire, and we don't have the time right now to fight unnecessary battles. Besides, she's not alone.
So why do you think Lady Beta keeps hiding her face like that?
Shh, be quiet. All right, tell us who you are and what you're doing here.
I am Beta of Shadow Garden.
Shadow Garden? The punks who burned down our school. So what? You're gonna burn the tower down now?
I was doing research on the possessed for reasons I can't go into now. And for that, I'm hoping for a blood sample from a progenitor vampire.
What do progenitor vampires have to do with the possessed?
When traced back to their origins, the possessed and vampires are the same. In the process of descendancy, the bloodlines changed and split off from one another. That's the theory we developed in the process of our research. So it's become necessary that we study the Blood Queen as she is a progenitor vampire.
The possessed and vampires are the same? That is blasphemy against the progenitors!
And why exactly would that make you angry? My dear thousand-year-old rumor, Miss Ancient Vampire Hunter.
So you know who I am.
We will stay out of your way. And you will stay out of our way. Can we just leave it at that?
Just tell me one thing. Is there a way to cure those who've become possessed?
Calm down now. You have absolutely nothing to worry about.
What does that mean?
Exactly what I said.
Fine. Let's go, Mary. If we keep wasting time here, we'll never save my brother.
Your brother?
The people here kidnapped him. If we don't hurry, he'll be sacrificed to the Blood Queen.
Is that really true? Is it true that... Number 666. Stand down, number 666.
But... I'm sorry.
I assume we're done here. Oh, and stay out of our way.
You have no desire to strive for the Haven once more?
Mary? Hey, hold on just a minute.
You disappoint me, number 666.
My deepest apologies.
And you two are supposed to keep her in line.
We're sorry, Miss Beta.
We're really sorry.
Our mission is simply to obtain the sample and nothing more. Lord Shadow will be the only one to deal with the Blood Queen. Got it? That will eliminate all problems, including the issue with the sacrifice. Do you understand, number 666?
Yes.
Babysitting is part of the job, Beta.
Go for the heart! Do it now!
Yeah, I know that!
Even an immortal vampire will die if its heart is destroyed. And they don't do well in the sun, you said? You're a vampire hunter, all right. You really know your stuff.
Come on, let's keep moving.
You're hiding something from me. You were acting strange back in the library, almost like you were taking the vampire's side. Just what is it you're after?
The Blood Queen.
But your purpose is to vanquish her, right?
I have lived this long only to achieve my purpose.
Then what was she talking about? What is the Haven? You don't look like an elf, but they've talked about you for 1,000 years.
Claire, you aren't any different. One who is possessed can never be a human again. It's so obvious, everyone knows it. So why would you ask that stupid question? Everyone has their secrets, you know that. I won't pry into yours, and you won't pry into mine. Can't that be good enough?
What happened?
Magical energy.
They say all you have to do is crush a vampire's heart to kill it. But you're still so weak. I thought this guy was one of the top brass. Well, whatever. Plenty more where he came from. Hey, losers. Tell me where I can find the Blood Queen.
Look who it is. Wait, you know him? Juggernaut the Tyrant. That's the boss at the Black Tower, right? And the one he's beating to a pulp is the third most powerful vampire in this tower. And the two on the floor? On the left is number 5, on the right is a lost number. Those titles make them sound tough. Juggernaut rose to the top to become one of the most powerful people in the Lawless City through sheer overwhelming violence. Let's wait here. We should avoid a fight with him if possible.
Agreed. Let's get out of here before he fights.
I have good instincts, you know. All right, you bat-faced bitch. You'll die if you know what's good for you.
Claire!
How dare you look away from me? I thought you'd be better than all those grumblings. Maybe my instincts are getting rusty. What? You're a tough little lady, aren't you? Most people I fight are down after they get the first punch from me.
You're only the second person who's ever managed to hit me in the face.
Isn't that an honor?
Mary, are you okay? Oh, no. Mary? Mary, please stay with me. Mary! It's okay. I know what to do. I'm all right. It's just been so long. Mary, please. I'm sorry, Claire. Let me suck your blood. I must. What are you doing? Mary. She wanted to live in harmony with the humans and voluntarily gave up blood.
As her subjects, we followed our queen's example and stopped drinking blood as well. As a result, we gradually lost our powers, but we gained other things in return. The ability to live in the light of the sun. Tranquil hearts no different than those of the humans. Our thirst for blood waned, and we were able to live in a beautiful world filled with light. But that was not so for Queen Elizabeth. No matter how far she removed herself from blood, the maddening thirst for it never left her. And when sunlight struck her, it would burn her skin hideously. Nevertheless,
let us build a haven here. A land where humans and vampires can live together in happiness.
The haven she strove for truly did exist in that place. I really believed that. But then came the night when the red moon rose in the sky. It happens once every 1,000 years. The night that gives vampires tremendous power. Queen Elizabeth was starving for blood, and Crimson gave her a single drop. Queen Elizabeth's frenzy lasted for 3 days and 3 nights. The haven disappeared into a pile of rubble, and 3 kingdoms suffered catastrophic damage. I survived by lapping up the blood of the dead, and went in pursuit of my queen. By the time I was reunited with her, it was all over.
This mistake must never be repeated. Scatter my ashes into the ocean so that my flesh can never revive.
Queen Elizabeth took a dagger and stabbed herself in the heart. If she had been an ordinary vampire, she would have disintegrated instantly. However, the queen never turned to ash. There she was, her breath stopped, her heart stilled. I could neither defy her wishes nor carry them out. It was then I realized all I could do was vow to watch over her in her eternal slumber. It was a foolish choice. Immediately after that, Crimson and his followers took my Lady Elizabeth from me.
Out of respect for your service to Her Majesty, I will spare you. I pray you will choose to join us by the next time the Red Moon rises in 1,000 years.
And now he is once again attempting to use her for his own selfish ambition. How can I possibly earn her forgiveness?
I'm no better than you. I might be possessed.
I began to show signs when I was just a little girl. One day I will become a monster too. I hoped I could help my brother achieve something important before that happened. That's why I brought him here. And now it's my fault he's... If anything happens to him because of me, how can I ever apologize? That's not true. So, your haven. Are you sure you can't build it again? I don't want to repeat the same mistake. Besides, I believe that Queen Elizabeth wants to die.
You won't know that unless you talk to her. I don't think what you tried to build was a mistake. I don't even want to think about that. It's too sad to let it end this way.
So let's do this thing together and go kick this Crimson guy's butt and get your queen back, okay?
What do you say?
Claire, I'm grateful. And I promise to help you rescue your brother, too.
I'm capable of doing that myself with panache. So mind your own business, all right?
How sweet! My heart is full! Just what I'd expect from a vampire's treasury. They have got quite the collection here. Oh yeah, I think I ran into my sister back there somewhere. Oh well, she can take care of herself, right? Pan Ko's famous painting, Slumber Hours. I got plenty of art. Pass. Jewels. They can be pretty unwieldy when they've already been inlaid into stuff. Another pass. That means my targets are pretty limited. One large coin worth 100,000 zenny. Plus, it's efficient and reliable and can be used as is. And most of all, it's extremely portable. Well, this is the world we live in after all, right? Just like Epsilon pads her chest with slime,
I will pad my slime with coins. 1,000 coins. 100 million zenny. I plan to live at least 300 years, so that's not gonna be nearly enough. But that's the way it has to be. I do have a boss battle coming up soon. I've been showing up fashionably late a lot recently, and it's starting to get old. I gotta change it up sometimes.
Operation, start the last boss battle before the named characters show up.
Whoa, what an intense battle! There's no way we can fight like that!
It's a go!
It's perfect. They've already announced that this time, the boss is a super powerful vampire. It's a pretty rare opportunity. Maybe I'll make an extra flashy entrance.
Your flesh and bones wasted away, leaving nothing but your heart. And even still, you're my beautiful queen. It's time for us to paint the world in blood once more. On this night so befitting us, a scarlet night of blood and terror.
Now return to life, beloved Elizabeth, and let us bind ourselves together in
The hour of awakening is near. The frenzy has begun.
Sensing Crimson's presence any longer, and I don't see the coffin anywhere. What in the world happened here?
Nothing but worry me.
I need Claire, look out!
Right now!
Sid!
Oh, Claire, no!
Stupid little bastard.
What do you think you're doing?
Shut up!
Anxiety. You were fully cured long ago. No surprise, because after all, he does know everything.
Fully cured? My possession is gone?
Who is he?
Someone you know very well.
But I don't know. What are you talking about? What's going on?
To put it simply, you are adapting, and unfortunately, you have lost control. Very soon, your body will turn into a rotting mess. So I'm going to give you just a little bit of help, alrighty?
Start making some sense! I have absolutely no idea what is happening! Where am I? Who are you? And who in the world is this he person?
That is an awful lot of questions. Is this a negative side effect of relaxed education policies? This is going to get a bit long. Heard of evolution? It's a theory proposed by a scientist suggesting that long ago people used to be monkeys. After many long years, those monkeys adapted to their environment and became humans.
What are you talking about? What does this have to do with my current situation?
But then, another scientist came along and proclaimed that living creatures do not adapt to their environment. In their harsh, natural environment, only the smartest monkeys survived. And eventually became humans.
I said, what are you talking about?
In other words, the monkeys didn't adapt intentionally. The ones that happened to already be adapted to the environment survived and changed physically. And then... what were we talking about?
I have no idea.
Oh, right. We were talking about adapting. The point is, the fact that the blood has divided into two different types is another result of adaptation. Possessed and progenitor vampires. The bloodline split in two, and the characteristics of each are clearly differentiated. And now, those two types of blood are trying to adapt inside of you. Sort of a good news, bad news situation. You have the right constitution for it, but you have no way to control it. And that's why the blood has gone berserk and your body is acting the way it is. Oh. Oh my. It's just about time.
Wait, you were about to say something important.
What? Hang in there, you're okay. That will teach you how to control your powers.
Can you explain it a little more?
There's no time. Things are really getting out of hand outside.
Come back! Who are you, and what is your deal? Why exactly are you helping me? Are you helping me?
My name is Aurora, and I helped you simply because you are his...
But who is he?
Lord Shadow.
Lord Shadow? How is this possible? Oh, Claire, is that you?
My first taste of freedom in about a month.
The Witch of Calamity. What the hell are you doing here? What happened to Claire?
What do you mean? Oh, I see you mean how I look. It's the same as what you both do. It's easier to move with my normal physique. The color change isn't magic, it's the reflection of the light. It's a little tight here. That's better. Now then, how much of this do you think you can handle? Sorry about that, but you know I am the original.
Who are you?
Stealing control of blood that has left its body isn't hard to do. It's really quite simple, as you can clearly see. You are lively. That's how you young people should be.
Oh, come on. So I guess anything goes?
It is rather over the top. And as a bonus, I'll show you the most almighty power that exists in the world.
What's this? No, you wouldn't dare!
I am the All. Oh dear, it looks like this body is the one that couldn't handle it.
Excuse me?
A little thing like this will heal in no time. You can do it too, can't you?
I can what? Not again.
It will be fine. This is enough, really. My work here is done. I was only buying time until he arrived, you understand?
He?
Indeed. He's quite the surprising individual.
This game has gone on long enough, Majesty.
Would you be so kind as to tell me your name?
Atomic.
Where you can be with the ones you love.
We're leaving now, 666.
That's that punk's gang. What do you call it again? Shadow Garden? I'm thinking it could be a lot of fun to go pick a fight with those pests.
This is our rise to adulthood.
We should consider ourselves lucky we're not dead.
My sword, my armor, everything is all gone.
Consider yourself lucky that you're alive.
Ghouls, vampires, the possessed, they all have different names, but in the end, they're all just magic overload. Curing it is easy. But there are afflictions out there that can't be cured.
My left arm is tingling. It's true. I have special power. Is my blood destiny trying to guide my life in a certain direction?
Bandages, magic circles, special powers. You guessed it. My sister's got it bad. But I can't dismiss her pain, because I, too, no. All children have walked this path at some point. And brushing off a child's concerns is what drives them to delinquency.
Sid. I think I should tell you. The thing is, there are special powers that have taken root in my left hand. And I have to solve the mystery of these powers.
If I know you, sis, you'll be fine. No matter what path you follow, I'll be behind you all of the way.
Thank you, Sid.
Sister has all kinds of trials and tribulations ahead of her. She'll have to confront her anxiety, her pain, reality. But her left hand has started tingling, so there's nothing we can do about it. Because that's how children grow into adults. We've been through a lot, but this event is now over. I struggled with a few unforeseen setbacks, but let's just say all's well that ends well. I never managed to recover all the gold coins. I was supposed to have 3,000, but the next thing I knew, there were only 500 left. With the current exchange rate, that's only 50 million zenny. Not nearly enough to support me my whole life. But if you think about it, maybe this is plenty. After all, The lawless city will always be there, and there are still two towers standing. If I'm ever in financial straits, I can just go back. Because the lawless city is my piggy bank.
Chump change for this card alone. Your business has been growing like crazy, and my boss thinks it's time for that to stop.
What's the name of your boss?
You've heard of Garner. He controls all the buying and selling in Midgar, and you dames went and made him mad.
Oh no, Mr. Garner? But everyone knows he's a respectable gentleman who serves as the president of the major corporate alliance.
And a faithful follower of the divine teachings who's made many donations to the church.
He's certainly not the type to hire a bunch of ruffians like you to interfere with honest business people.
Then I guess you learned something, didn't you? Even righteous people have a hidden dark side. Garner only made it as big as he did by employing people like us to achieve his ambitions.
I don't believe it makes a difference to tell us what we already know.
Huh?
I will admit there is value in testimony from an involved party. Every person alive has a hidden dark side. Righteous or wicked. Exceptional or ordinary. Whether a man or a woman.
Women! All in black! No! You can't be!
Unsheathe the sword of judgment. It's true. Night is best when it's quiet. I believe we have reduced their legitimate ranks considerably with this operation. So then now... Ah, yes. The underworld players connected to the cult should start to show themselves. The war is about to begin.
Don the latest in fashion from Kamsadu Mitsugoshi, the eyes of every girl on the street will be...
Laser focus! First they'll hit on us, and then the smooching will begin!
Guaranteed!
Kamsadu Mitsugoshi. Anything related to design probably came from Ada. First Gamma, then Beta, and Epsilon. Man, every single one of them is just running wild. Looks like something's peeling off your shirt.
What? The Kamsadu Mitsugoshi logo!
Without that, these clothes are just cheap knockoffs!
On the other hand, if we stick these on our other clothes, then they'll be Kamsadu Mitsugoshi. Huh?
This brand is lame.
It's the logo of the place we bought these from!
Does this mean mine is too?
Now that I look at this up close, it does seem kind of off. The real one is more, you know, intricate or something. It's no wonder these clothes were so cheap.
Come to think of it, all of my outfits were curated by Alpha and the girls. Everything I'm wearing is like a knockoff from my past life. I saw people walking around the capital wearing suits and thought that was just the culture here. But it looks like that was all Alpha's doing too. I guess they're using my knowledge from my past life to increase their market share as far as they can make it go. And I bet the people they're stealing business from are none too happy about it. The people they're stealing business from, those people aren't happy! They're not happy! But that all ends today, my friends.
Where are you going?
Dropping a deuce?
No. I'm going to reclaim what's mine. Every bit of it.
What's that all about?
No idea. Doesn't he know that summer's already over?
As of today, I am a super elite secret agent.
Starting tonight, the world will know my name!
Welcome. My dear Shadow.
forsaken that name.
Of course, how silly of me. Mr. John Smith, right? It is truly heartening to have you so kindly join our ranks.
It is a profitable arrangement for myself, that is all.
But don't you find it depressing to maintain a relationship based solely on profit?
Don't you?
Why? How unfriendly. The other day, Garter arranged for an impromptu meeting of the major corporate alliance. Something about strengthening their measures against Mitsugoshi. I suspect the fall of Mitsugoshi may come sooner than we had anticipated.
I see.
However, our plan remains unchanged. While Mitsugoshi and the major corporate alliance work to destroy each other,
we covertly take everything.
We will need you to take action for us, Mr. Smith. But do be careful. Behind the major corporate alliance, you will find him. The underworld swordsman who rose above Garter and took control of the MCA before anyone knew what was happening. Kitan, the sword devil. I know the man well. He is a dangerous cur who will stop at nothing to get what he wants. But he's mine. I swear I'll... I look forward to seeing it. In the battle for control over the market in the royal capital, at the end of the conflict where money is bought with blood, who will remain standing?
I will destroy it all, then build it up again.
The moment you've all been waiting for! The Garter Corporation, friend to every family's budget, starts our big autumn sale right now!
Listen up! The battle we're about to face is where blood is wiped away with
blood! Our target is 50% off!
Step right up and have a look.
Garter's not the only one. We have bargain prices on everything.
Check out the selection at this hidden gem, Highway Robert's.
Major sales all across the shopping district.
We won't let Mitsugoshi get us down.
So basically Alpha and the girls have gone too far. They're selling exclusive products you can only find at their stores. Not only have they made enemies of the big corporations, but local distributors have it out for them too. Now that they've earned the loathing of the entire rest of the industry, yeah, Yukime was right. The future of Mitsugoshi is pretty much devoid of all hope. I will destroy it all, then build it up again. They will crush Mitsugoshi, and I will crush them. I will use the massive amounts of capital that remain to move to a brand new market and start up a new corporation. I'll invite Alpha and the girls to come on as upper management. Then I just change the name, and Mitsugoshi will be reborn. Once it's all over, then they'll understand. They'll know that this was the best choice.
Okay, out of 5,000 zinni?
You break it, you buy it? Really? I can't believe it. This is why people like Mitsugoshi so much better.
Well, what did you expect?
That's 1,750 zinni and change.
Huh? Is it me, or does that bill look wrong?
What do you mean? Wrong how?
I don't remember that being the design.
Oh, wait a sec. I know what this is. It's the new bill that the Major Corporate Alliance just put out.
That's why everything's on sale today, to commemorate the release of the new bill.
So what bills were we using before these?
Here, look at this one. From the Mitsugoshi Bank.
Mitsugoshi.
Before, we were only able to use them at official Mitsugoshi storefronts.
But now we can use them anywhere, all over the city.
Those punks have their own bank now, too?
Over the summer break, and, well...
Now that I think of it, I do remember babbling on about some random facts I saw on an MHK documentary about banks and credit creation.
But what if there ends up being polarity in the market?
If that's the case, find a different provider for a different price.
My memories of it were fuzzy. I couldn't trust my knowledge anymore, so I ended that conversation. But those girls took that MHK information and ran with it. Not only did they establish their own bank, they even managed to issue their own paper currency. So, and they've even inspired copies. I mean, respectful homages. Copies? The Mitsugoshi banknote uses multicolored printing and a carefully placed watermark. But this copycat version has cruder printing and a simpler design. That means...
Let's go!
When I was a child, I had a dream.
Huh?
I had a 1,000 yen bill left from my New Year's money. And I thought, maybe I could make more of them with the copy machine at the corner store.
The what now?
Who cares? Give me my money back.
I gave up on the idea after the old man at the counter yelled his head off at me.
What is this about?
Sid, my money.
But now he can't stop me. I'm a super elite secret agent, and dreams can come true.
Wait, Sid!
Come back!
Come on, Brain! Remember! I'm counting on you, MHK! Sid!
Sid, my money!
This single gold coin multiplies into several times of what it was. In actuality, it is the fleeting illusion we call credit.
Are you, perchance, talking about paper money?
Scraps of paper considered to be no different than currency are not really currency at all. They are no more than claim checks for coins that have been left in the care of the bank. For example, if you put 10,000 zenny in the bank, in exchange you are given a banknote for 10,000 zenny, which you can use to purchase goods and services. But this is where something strange occurs. You have 10,000 zenny in the bank and 10,000 zenny in a banknote. At some point, your zenny has doubled to 20,000. If the 10,000 zenny in the bank remains dormant in its vault, there is no problem. Because even if the money had, in fact, doubled, as long as only the original 10,000 zenny circulates through the market, there is no contradiction. But the bank has used the 10,000 zenny deposited as collateral to lend out even more money.
The robust economy of the capital stemmed from the business developments of Mitsugoshi. Seeing a good opportunity, the merchants wished to borrow some capital, and the bank met the demand by supplying paper money. Is that correct?
No one wants to walk around with heavy coins in their pockets. Use of paper money spread like wildfire, further obscuring the currency's true value. The 10,000 zenny in the vault multiplied to several times what it was, circulated through the capital, and Mitsugoshi gained exponential profits by reaping the rewards of the interest. This is the true value of credit creation.
Credit creation. What a fitting expression that is. Through these means, a simple scrap of paper not even worth a copper coin is given more value than gold. The leader of Mitsugoshi Bank must be an extraordinary con artist. What might this person be like, I wonder? If I ever have the chance, I would love to have a chat.
But really, is a simple piece of paper truly worth the credit people give it? Compare the two. Do you notice anything?
You mean a watermark on one, but not the other?
And I might add that the major corporate alliance bill has a rougher design. Rougher printing, rougher edges. Do you know what this means?
It would be easy to make a fake.
We create fake money, and we'll make a fortune in counterfeit bills.
Excuse me, Mr. Smith. As you are no doubt aware, the major corporate alliance bills are still only in circulation in the royal capital. If we forged them, the authorities would immediately trace them to the source.
Huh?
If done on a small scale, I'm sure it could be accomplished without discovery, but the amount would be hardly more than a child's allowance. How do you propose that we do this?
Is that really? Oh. Is that really what you think? This is the true value of credit creation.
You can't mean... If we did make and circulate a large quantity of counterfeit bills in a short period of time, we would be discovered. And rumors of the bills would reach the ears of the general public almost immediately. At that point, the citizens would harbor doubts about the contents of their own wallets. The credit given to that paper would be lost. The discovery of the counterfeiting was part of the plan. No, the discovery was the plan. When the people start to doubt the value of the paper, they will make a run on the bank to exchange it for gold. If we stay one step ahead of the game, then we can monopolize the profits. That's what you've been planning all along.
Is that really what you think?
This plan is utterly flawless.
That is exactly right.
had given in to the pressure and rattled off some thoughtless babblings, then I... John Smith, the man formerly known as Shadow.
John Smith, the mysterious man secretly scheming while Mitsugoshi and the major corporate alliance battle it out. He hides his identity and carries out his mission alone. I am the man who betrays his organization in order to save it. The super elite secret agent. What could be cooler than that? What does she think she's doing?
Oh, give me more, boss! Give me some more! You smell like foxes!
Yeah, I was hanging out with... Rather, I mean, I was out hunting foxes.
Hunting? Delta wants to hunt?
Sorry, the fox is already hunted. And would you get off me already?
No! Hunt!
What are you doing in the capital anyway?
Delta woke up early this morning, ate lots and lots of meat, and came to the capital for the first time in forever!
Yeah, but why did you come to the capital?
Because Delta likes to go hunting!
And why were you hunting?
Delta did so much hunting! Wanna hunt with me, boss?
Why were you hunting?
Lady Alpha told me to. Wanna hunt with me, boss?
So Alpha told you to do it, huh?
Uh-huh. Wanna hunt with me, boss?
Now that you're here, what have you been hunting?
Bandits. You like hunting bandits too, boss?
Yeah, I do like hunting bandits. You're right about that.
Hunt with me.
I don't think I can right now.
You hunt!
Hold your horses. Anyway, didn't you come to the capital for a specific reason?
Reason?
Didn't Alpha want to see you? Did you forget?
Yeah, I forgot. She's gonna be so mad at me!
You better hurry and see her.
But we're supposed to go hunt bandits.
Looking at Delta reminds me of John, the pet I had in my past life.
Another failure.
Yes, sir. Their private soldiers are more powerful than we anticipated.
So it seems the would-be bandits are useless. In that case, I'll send the Clovers after them.
Send the Clovers? Those are the elite assassins you handpicked yourself, Mr. Catan. With them on the job, Mitsugoshi's secrets are as good as ours.
Delta is fundamentally incapable of following the command stay. Her brand of hunting is a one-sided massacre. It makes gathering treasure easier, but... I totally missed out on the element of enjoying the battle myself.
Stop! Wait a minute!
Hmm?
You're Sara, aren't you? It's me! You know me! Me! You know! It's me, Sabra! You remember, don't you, Sara?
Hmm? You smell a lot like my dad.
Yes, that's right, like Dad! I'm your big brother, Sabra! But how is it that you're even alive and standing here? I heard you got possessed and Dad hunted you.
Delta is the very best at hide and seek.
Delta? Is that what you call yourself now? Anyway, Sara, you can let me go, right? I'm working for the Great Catan now. You know him, the legendary man.
I don't want a weak brother.
He's your brother. You sure you wanted to do that?
Weaklings bring shame to the family, boss.
Okay.
Delta's daddy is the chief of our clan. He has lots of lovers and over 1,000 children to care for.
Then I guess one less won't hurt him.
If we need to make more, we make more! Because that is the law of the clan!
That's a Therianthrope for you. They do things a bit different. You do find the occasional intelligent Therianthrope, but there's a reason most people assume they're a bunch of might-makes-right types. Maybe sometime, I should visit the Therianthrope land.
I just had a great idea! You can be our chief, boss!
What?
If you beat my dad, you'll be the chief! Then you can have lots of babies and we'll be the strongest clan ever!
That's not happening.
Yes, it is! I'll get 100 women for you, and Delta will have 100 babies!
No way, not a chance. This hunt is over. We're going home.
Zabra has been defeated, you say?
Yes, sir. One of our underground hideouts was attacked, and we found his body inside. And, sir, I'm afraid that these last few months our numbers have been reduced to practically nothing. If this keeps up, it will affect the personnel we have running our public enterprises. We have invested a rather large amount of capital in establishing our bank, and the amount of money we spent bribing the legislators so we could print our money is nothing to be sneezed at. Perhaps we should step back and reevaluate?
Garter.
Sir?
You are in a position to control all commerce in the city. Surely you have not forgotten who it was who put you in that position.
No, sir! No, of course, I haven't!
All you need to do is follow orders. My orders. It doesn't matter. Zabra was the weakest of the Clovers. Summon the three Clovers that are left. Strengthen our offense against Mitsugoshi and take all of their trade secrets.
Yes, sir!
Mitsugoshi is tougher than I thought. Now I see why the cult labeled them as a threat.
We are succeeding in minimizing the attacks against our transport trains, and we are dominating in the marketplace. The major corporate alliance lacks our wisdom, so supplying paper money and creating credit is too much. If these circumstances continue, I believe they will be crushed under the weight of their own ambition.
Just as we predicted. But remember, as I'm sure you already know,
we will not take any actions that would implicate Mitsugoshi's connection to Shadow Garden. Of course, that means we will be forced to rely on passive measures for the time being.
It only takes a moment for trust to be destroyed. We must devote the utmost care to maintaining that trust. Surely he taught you that as well.
Indeed. For now, we must refrain from any brash behavior.
I beg your pardon, but we have guests.
Unlike Garter Kikuchi, this man seems to have very little patience.
He looks so young. He can't suppress his warrior, or rather his therianthrope nature. In any case, Nu, I know it's late, but treat our guests with the proper—
Pardon, Lady Alpha. Would you please allow me to handle this situation?
What?
What?
In any case, Nu, I know it's late, but treat our guests with the proper—
Pardon, Lady Alpha. Would you please allow me to handle this situation?
You?
Yes, Lady Alpha. I will teach our visitors a lesson.
Really? You two, go with her. Well, I'm sure it will be fine. She is 17 years old, after all.
What?
What?
Way too easy to get in.
Probably using all their security to guard their transports.
Our target is the manager, an elf woman known as Luna. Let's find her office. Is that...
Thank you for coming to Mitsugoshi. Pleased to meet you. I am the manager, Luna, and I am here to welcome you to our store.
There's no sign of any bodyguard. Her confidence is a bluff. I am the man who earned the title of Leaf One, strongest of the Clovers. No one has engaged me in battle and come out unscathed. If you don't want to die, then be a good girl and say goodnight.
You're supposed to start with a powerful frontal attack and then just play it by ear, don't you know that?
Huh?
This is the trouble with entitled customers.
That black artifact. It can't be. She's fast. But...
Take that! And that!
That's all she is. She's fast, but she's a total amateur.
Footwork! You must be a student of the Western Lichtenroy style of fencing, am I right?
What? She identified my fighting style that quickly?
Now that I know your style, I can easily counter it! Take that, and that, and that, and that!
She should be able to predict my every move now! Her approach is exactly the same! She's an amateur! Sure, that was a direct hit. So why? What the hell is going on?
You are quite the skilled warrior to be able to land such a hit on me.
Very well. I grant you the honor of facing my full fury for that.
Damn it. What the hell is with all this excessive magical energy and the battle cry?
Now hear what my great lord and master taught me.
Yeah, let me think. For you, Gamma, your stats are ridiculously high, so... to start with...
jam some magical energy into it and hack away!
Yeah.
And when you slash, make sure to look intimidating! Take that, then! Well played, my good sir. Acting as though you were only evading my attack while using the lay of the land to set a clever trap. I'd expect nothing less from a Grand Master of Lichtenroy.
Your nose is bleeding. Anyway, I don't want anything more to do with this woman. I mean, apparently she is too much for me to handle. I need to move on to something else. Men, it's time you quit messing around. We need to beat a tactical...
After you missing children? We have been looking after them for you.
Huh?
Be careful, you two! This man standing here has mastered the Lichtenroy technique. He's most likely one of the best fencers in the world.
I must say, that is impressive.
No, I'm not. You got it wrong. I'm just...
But I see a secret behind your eminent power. From now on, I will show you my full strength.
Please, make it stop! Screw this!
You won't get away! Secret technique. Self-sacrifice spinning wheel.
Your nose is bleeding.
The Clovers haven't returned, you say?
Yes, sir. Unfortunately, neither have the reinforcements we sent, and we have even lost contact with the lookout team. Also, Mr. Gatan, there are several members of the major corporate alliance that have ties with Mitsugoshi. My fear is that this failure, I mean this little incident, will get them talking again.
Then shut them up.
Yes, sir.
I should have known better than to give them the name Clovers. They could never have made those sorry excuses for bandits equal to the Knights. I would have liked to use some of the children, but the cult is running low on resources as well. First Xenon, then that old fossil. They're both dead, but they're still getting in my way. But that is exactly why this is the perfect opportunity for me to demonstrate my power. The major corporate alliance is nothing more than a disposable pawn. I only need them to stay afloat long enough for me to complete my preparations. Just a little while longer. Someday soon. Power that no one will be able to take away from me.
Just keep getting better.
Really?
Was it a change of mindset? Or did she figure something out? When a character suddenly gets a lot better, it's usually one of those things.
But it still isn't enough yet. I just need a bit more power.
Cool.
So aren't you gonna ask me why?
Why then?
I did nothing. All I could do was watch from the side. Now Rose has gone off alone.
Orianna has lost its king. It's a real mess right now. And she's... My friend is suffering, and I just need a bit more power so I can fight back. But there are a lot of other things that I'm lacking, too. While we lead our everyday lives, the world keeps moving forward in secret. If I don't move with it, I'll be left behind. I don't want to be an outsider anymore. It's strange. Since I started actively choosing to move forward, time has started to move faster.
That's just how it is.
It must be nice to be so carefree. I sincerely hope you can be that carefree your whole life. Extra large noodle with extra veggies, no fat or garlic.
Coming up!
Production has been completed, Mr. Smith.
Then it's time.
Here you go. Enjoy.
This domain was formerly ruled by Viscount Grease. Currently, it's run by a local magistrate with weak law enforcement. Naturally, they wouldn't spare any personnel to inspect the abandoned mine at the edge of the domain. I'm truly happy that this place was brought to my attention. We produce our counterfeit bills here, transport them temporarily to the Lawless City, then we disguise our distribution channels and introduce them to the royal capital of Midgar. So, Mr. Smith, what do you think? For all the time we devoted to creating the printing plates, I believe the finished product is quite good. Of the two, can you tell which is the authentic bill?
The answer goes without saying. On comparison, one of them uses paper of slightly coarser quality. There are differences in the bleed of the ink. And surely I don't need to describe the distortions in the print?
It's true. But we double and triple checked.
I don't need to point out any more than that, do I?
You do not.
Obviously, the bill of lesser quality is the fake one.
What?
What?
It appears that you perfected it to such a high degree that you have surpassed the authentic article.
I had not foreseen that possibility. Shall we start over and make new ones?
That won't be necessary. I doubt anyone other than myself will be able to tell the difference.
I am no match for your intellect, Mr. Smith. I was thinking we would begin distribution right away. Does that suit you?
Yes.
Once there are more bills in circulation, the authorities will look for the source. I am counting on you, Mr. Smith, to handle that situation as planned. But Gitan, that repulsive man, is all mine, got it? He is mine.
Revenge?
Gitan took everything from me. My mother, my friends, my entire village. Now it's my turn. I will take everything from him just as he did from me. I will kill him. But not until after I've taken it all.
Have it your way, then. But take care that you don't turn down the wrong path.
Counterfeit bills?
Yes, ma'am. Of the major corporate alliance's currency. We found them in several of our stores throughout the capital.
I see that our decision to accept our competitor's currency has actually borne fruit.
Although originally that was so we could take credit away from their currency, not ours.
How much is in circulation?
Not much yet. The customers who paid with them are unaware that the bills were counterfeit, so we haven't determined where they infiltrated in from.
Does the major corporate alliance know about this?
They don't
don't seem to have realized it yet. They're working to issue more bills without a care in the world.
See to it that they do realize. If the citizens find out that their money is counterfeit, we'll have a crisis on our hands. If anything happens to inspire doubt in the value of paper money, it will hurt our business as well. Impossible. Was that their plan all along? To instigate a credit collapse? But that would bring about their own downfall as well.
Lady Alpha?
It's nothing. Find out where the counterfeit bills are coming from. That's our top priority.
Right. Yes, Lady Alpha.
If this turns out to be more than a minor cash grab, then who could be behind it? And why?
A counterfeit bill, you say?
Yes, sir. A cashier at one of our corporate stores found it just a little while ago.
Which one is it?
Sir? Oh, yes, of course, it was... I believe it was the poorly made one. I think, maybe?
No matter. Find out where it came from.
Yes, sir. I will get on it right away, sir.
The number of banknotes we currently have in circulation exceeds the value of the MCA assets that give them their credit. The same should be true for Mitsugoshi. The only thing that can guarantee the value of paper money anymore is the vague concept of the credit given to it by the unenlightened masses. A counterfeit bill. A piece of paper like the banknotes, but without the guaranteed value promised to the real ones. It's a genuine, worthless scrap of paper. If the world were to learn of their existence, every citizen would simultaneously begin to harbor doubts. They will fear that even the real bills in their own wallets may be nothing more than paper. Those offhand feelings, that vague ideation, that is what will cause the collapse of the credit given to paper money. That is why we had been preparing to begin circulating our own counterfeit bills. By intentionally bringing about the downfall of credit, we would bankrupt the major corporate alliance and the abominable Mitsugoshi company with it. That was the mission given to me by the cult. But the plan wasn't supposed to go into effect until after we had recovered all the cult assets that were hidden within the MCA. Those assets are mixed up in our more public businesses and organizations. It should take time and effort to retrieve them. Did they not understand that when they enacted this plan? If we sit back and watch as the counterfeit bills go into circulation, the cult could end up losing enormous amounts of money. What is this? What is happening?
Confirming target now. We know that this train is carrying cargo from the Lawless City, and that cargo includes the counterfeit bills mingled with other stolen goods. We'll let the other team search for the counterfeiters while we move to recover the bills in question. Number 666, you'll follow my orders. I'm the leader, and I make the decisions.
Yes, ma'am, I understand.
No, you don't. That's why I'm reminding you. The last mission and the one before that. What are you always so panicked about?
I am not always panicked.
There you go, keeping everything bottled up. We can't understand you if you don't talk to us.
Now, that's enough, you two. Right now, we need to focus on the mission at hand.
You're right. Hey, you just ate something, didn't you?
I'm not eating anything.
You put something in your mouth. I know you did. We are on the job. You can at least wait until...
There aren't any passengers.
The train is transporting contraband, so that makes sense, but...
Strange, because we're not seeing any guards on board either.
Be careful!
Huh? Now then. Might I see your tickets, please?
Oh, very funny! You think this works?
Well, it's kind of unbreakable, you know? Magically reinforced thread.
Who are you?
I am John Smith. You are within death's reach to
eliminate the distance between you and your enemy. You made the correct choice, however. You're too inexperienced to risk it all on a single attack.
Number 666!
I had a feeling you people would be the first to figure it out. But it's too soon. You do not need to learn anything more. Yes!
Without a plan, we'll fall into the same trap. Surely you're smart enough to understand that.
It looks like they started speeding up. I don't think we can catch up now, even if we run.
We'll go back and report to Lady Gamma. Understood?
Yes.
John Smith. That power. How can this be? Why am I so weak?
And that is our report. He was against three of the elite numbers.
John Smith, huh? I don't know that name. Could he possibly be a new member of the Named Children?
I don't know. It's also possible he's a resident of the Lawless City. The Black Tower's influence is...
John Smith is above the most skilled of fighters! It was like he predicted our every move!
Hey, you can't do that!
He's as good as the Seven Shadows! His power is equal to yours!
You need to be quiet!
I beg you, let me go face him again!
And I'm begging you to stop! 665!
Okay!
Let go of me! I'm not done! It's time for you!
Are you trying to get yourself killed?
Well, good night! That's another problem we're going to have to deal with.
I've assigned Zeta to the search for what we discussed.
I want to think that she hasn't contacted us because the mission is going smoothly.
The cult seems to be putting up some heavy resistance.
I hope we can put an end to this quickly. Then we can have some time to relax.
Lady Alpha.
We'll send Delta to deal with John Smith.
Yes, good plan. That would be best.
By a super elite secret agent.
That's so cool! Delta can go too!
No, this is something only I can do. And if you report to Alpha about John Smith, my hush-hush secret mission will end in failure. You don't want that, do you?
Why?
Because it won't be a secret anymore. So I need you to not tell anyone.
But Delta is on another mission for Lady Alpha.
It's okay. I'm going to give you a new mission. You remember the rules of Shadow Garden, don't you?
No, I do not!
Any mission I give you takes priority over anything else, even a mission from Alpha.
And Lady Alpha won't get mad at me?
She won't get mad.
She really won't get mad?
She really won't get mad. After all, this is to save the world.
Save the world?
That's right, save the world. So I'm sorry. But when you finish your mission, I'll give you something for a reward.
A reward? Boss will give me anything I want?
No, not anything. It has to be something I'm capable of. And something that doesn't take too much effort. And something that doesn't cost any money. And then I'll see if I can make it happen.
Boss is gonna do whatever I say!
Under my conditions.
He'll listen to anything I say!
Under my conditions.
I got a mission!
And your mission is... Hang on, let me think. If you keep going straight from here, you'll get to a place called the Lawless City. There's a black tower there with a big bad guy named Juggernaut. Go hunt him.
Lawless Black Jugga Jugga.
Exactly. Black Jugga Jugga.
And I hunt him.
You hunt him.
And Boss will do what I say.
Under my conditions.
You'll do anything I say.
Under my conditions.
Got it! I'm going hunting!
Something seems a bit off about this, but oh well. It is to save the world, right? And as for Alpha, it's fine. I'm sure she'll be home by the time the weather warms up.
And Delta?
We found the aftermath of an intense battle. It's at that battle that we believe that's when this was cut off. It's unthinkable that she would abandon a mission. She, that stupid mutt. She was stupid, but she never defied an order from you, Lady Alpha.
Continue the search. I hope to at least retrieve the body.
Lady Alpha, the amount of counterfeit bills in circulation is still increasing. At this rate, the citizens will begin to doubt the value of all paper money. And the wave of demands for redemption will bear down on everyone, including Mitsugoshi. We don't have the assets that will be required to satisfy the predicted demand. We need a plan, and urgently. We must eliminate John Smith.
This was what he wanted from the start. This was no shallow attempt to earn extra zenny with counterfeit bills. While we were off busy fighting a commerce war with a major corporate alliance, he was planting seeds to sow. Seeds to intentionally spark a credit crisis, bankrupt us both, and take everything for himself.
He didn't want profit generated by the market, but the market itself to constantly generate profit? His plan is actually that ambitious?
John Smith.
The cult is highly concerned about the current state of affairs. If these mysterious counterfeit bills continue to circulate, it will expedite the credit collapse, and the cult will suffer severe losses. Mr. Gatan, sir, this is more than a question of your personal...
John Smith, you say?
Yes, sir. When we attempted to uncover the source of the counterfeit bills, a man calling himself John Smith stopped us.
Garden.
Sir?
Set up checkpoints. Inspect everything going in and out of the Royal Capital.
That might be a problem. We have a lot of clout, but if we tried that, the Royal Family would...
Do whatever you must to find the source of those counterfeit bills.
Yes, sir!
Did you hear about the major corporate alliance?
You mean inspecting every piece of cargo? The Minister of Transportation and the Commander of the Knights are both hopping mad about it.
They're not even trying to pretend anymore. We let something slide because the economy...
This was... And so... Alexia? Oh, hello, Iris. I know there's no school today, but I didn't expect to see you at the castle. They haven't finished rebuilding the academy yet, so I thought it might be easier to find specialized books in the palace archives. Specialized? On all kinds of things. Law, politics, engineering, economics. Oh, and ancient linguistics, too.
Are you going to give up the sword and become a scholar?
Not at all. Rather, this is to help me know where to wield my sword. Since this spring, I've been forced to realize a lot of things. If I just keep swinging my sword around at random, that's never going to change anything. I'll only ever be an outsider. If I want to wield my sword in a place where it matters, then I have to start by earning the right to stand in that place. And the road to that place sometimes starts in an area where you don't wield a sword. I had to learn that the hard way. Because of that, now I have no time for anything. Of course, I could never neglect my training. Iris?
Whoa! Rumors of the counterfeit bills are already beginning to spread throughout the royal capital. The royal family will be forced to take action soon. Setting up unauthorized checkpoints had a negative impact. The adverse effects on the marketplace are immeasurable and already... Huh?
What is it?
Oh, it's just, my lord, are you taking down notes?
Yes, because this will affect the future.
Is the situation really that dire? My apologies. I'll continue.
Keep it brief.
Because these circumstances can easily lead to inflation, it has already reached a point that it must be addressed at the state level.
Doesn't make sense.
Uh-huh. Does my report have a mistake? We'll restart the investigation right away.
No, there's no time to spare. Let's just proceed as we have been.
I'm deeply sorry about this. If I may, there's one more thing. Something I must report. To deal with John Smith, we sent Delta after him. As a result, we've lost all contact with her. We believe she may have been killed in action.
What?
What?
Nothing. No, wait. I mean, Delta has... Yeah, Delta has gone somewhere far away, that's all.
Oh, yes, of course. Delta has only gone somewhere far away, that's all.
Is she hibernating or what?
John Smith is a considerably skilled fighter. If possible, Lord Shadow, we would like you to...
Apologies. I have matters to attend to.
Of course, I understand. Please forgive me for asking too much. My lord, about those notes. As you know, Shadow Garden has a rule that classified documents must either be destroyed or encrypted without delay. Huh?
Read it to me.
But my lord, it's such a complex code. Did you develop this all on your own?
Hiragana, katakana, kanji, Arabic numbers, Roman. It uses 5 languages that I developed independently.
Oh, I'd love for you to teach me!
Maybe I will. If you can decipher the meaning of this text, then I will enlighten you. I will share a part of my wisdom with...
Mr. Smith.
Hmm?
We are approaching the major corporate alliance checkpoint.
Keep going.
So we're really allowed to take it out?
If they don't stop, make sure they have an accident. Those are our orders.
But there's no way the Knights would just let us-
We got no choice! If we don't, our lives in the black market are over!
I don't care who he is. When you get down to it, Garter's just a merchant.
Not him, damn it. Don't you know that Garter's back by-
Now what?
We go into hiding. And if we're lucky, we may survive. As long as those monsters don't find us.
It's a pleasure to meet you, John Smith. Now goodbye. Decoy threads hiding finer threads that will deal real damage. That means...
You can dodge them. Makes sense, I guess.
Delta!
I have sent her to a far-off place.
Maybe you can understand it, but it makes absolutely no sense to me! I am not capable of doing the extraordinary things that you can do! However, despite that, I want to support you, to understand you! I want to be there for the man who saved my life! For you, if it would serve you, I would... But then you go and... Does this mean you don't need me anymore?
Once it's all over, you'll understand. You'll know this was the best choice.
I won't be like this forever, you know. I won't keep dragging you down!
Circulation has increased by the addition of the counterfeit bills, and prices have gone up. These circumstances can easily lead to inflation, and it has already reached a point that it must be addressed at a state level. This will be the perfect time to end it.
You saw that far ahead? I'm impressed, as always. We could never have succeeded in this plan without your help, Mr. Smith.
Surely I can't take all the credit.
Oh, you flatter me. I believe I have told you before, about the time when I was younger, and I resided in a small village with my mother. Back then, the great hero Shiva had just fallen, and the Therianthrope lands were plunged into a maelstrom of war. The powerful clans were in constant conflict to claim the crown of the great hero, and the weaker clans, like my Spirit Fox clan, were constantly at their mercy. In our quest for survival, we attempted to deepen our ties with the like-minded clans that were our allies. It seemed like the natural course of action. The powerful clan of the Great Wolves and the wise clan of the Spirit Foxes. Two were chosen to marry to strengthen our alliance. Me, the daughter of the only Spirit Fox to have three tails, and the son of the Great Wolves' patriarch, the Swordsman Gatan. I admired Gatan and accepted my appointment with joy. And Gatan had affection for me, too. My mother and everyone in the village gave us their blessing. It was such a happy time. But then... war broke out nearby between two great clans. Our village was caught in a crossfire, and just like that, it was destroyed. The wisdom and strength of the lesser clans amounted to nothing more than helplessness.
I have made a proposal to the other clans. I told them the only way to survive is to accept more power. If we take these pills, They will grant us immense power. We could have stood up against the greater clans. We could have broken out of this constant state of war. But that woman refused. Because of her, they all refused. They all died. We could have stopped this before it happened. Yes, that's right. I did that. I was the one who killed her. I had to do it. To protect you from this war.
Gatan!
The only way to stop them from taking from us is to start taking from them.
Gatan!
Come. Pledge fealty to the cult and accept their power for yourself.
Gatan!
You're just like the rest of them. You dare reject me! If I don't take from them, they'll take from me. If I don't take from them, they'll take from me. If I don't take from them.
He took everything from me, leaving me with nothing but an arch nemesis, Gatan. I ended up as a prostitute on the battlefield. I needed wealth. I needed power. I used everything I possibly could. Until I found myself at the Lawless City and climbed to the top. Surely by now you've caught on, Mr. Smith. You know that my true objective is not to build myself a fortune. I will find Gatan, and then take everything that he has built up for himself.
That maybe it was the same thing with her.
I'm going to settle this once and for all. I do hope you will wait for my return, trusting in my success.
Have been going around to the branch offices redeeming their money for gold all day.
Wait, this branch is temporarily closed?
How can you do that to us? So the rumors really weren't true. These banknotes are just worthless scraps of paper now.
You still haven't found out where the counterfeit bills are coming from.
No, sir. We haven't yet pinpointed the factory that's printing them. However, we've identified the person behind it, Yuki Mei. Tower in Lawless City. A carriage from Snow Fox Corporation was used to transport the gold coins that had been exchanged. And the Snow Fox Corporation happens to be the public face of the White Tower.
Coincidence.
The route to transport the money is an exact...
I knew she had stooped to prostitution, but
been investigating. Sir! What is it? What's the matter, sir?
Storefronts, bringing the citizens' unrest to its peak. Riots are breaking out at all of the bank branches. Customers are demanding to exchange their money, and we're struggling to control the situation.
Can we weather the storm?
If things carry on like this, it will only be a few days before our bank vault is empty. Even with all of our domestic and foreign assets combined, we won't survive a credit collapse.
I see.
But things are going to be all right. If we provide something for the marketplace to have a sense of security, surely we can stop this catastrophe. For example, we could show the public that we have giant stacks of gold coins.
Forget it. It doesn't matter anymore. He's the one that put the counterfeit bills in circulation. He's the one who caused the credit collapse. This is what he wanted. He has forsaken us.
No way! He would never do that to us! Lord Shadow would never abandon us like that!
I'm afraid we failed to live up to his expectations. And this is the result. He gave us the best of everything. Environment, knowledge. But in the end, we failed to reach his level. He has washed his hands of our incompetence.
No!
If it is what you wish, I will give you my life. That was my promise. Please excuse me. We found solid evidence. Listen to me. The man known as Gatan is leading an operation for the cult of Diablos. He conspired to circulate counterfeit bills in a plot to bankrupt the Mitsugoshi Corporation.
Then he's prepared to destroy himself, even without our connection to Shadow Garden. They saw Mitsugoshi as a powerful threat and they attempted to destroy us. While we were busy fighting economic warfare, he was watching. Lord Shadow saw the truth, and he went alone to...
He knew about the counterfeit bills? The cult had been plotting to put counterfeit bills into circulation. Yes. However, the cult hasn't begun to circulate any false banknotes.
But there are still definitely counterfeits going around. No. No, the bills that are currently in circulation are...
Yes. Shadow created this entire scenario. He changed his name, stopped communicating, then circulated his counterfeit bills before the cult could do theirs. But to what end?
Lady Alpha! This is huge! We just finished deciphering the coded message that Lord Shadow gave to me! Look at this! Ada, crack the code! Here's what it says.
Lady Alpha!
I can't believe it. He hasn't abandoned us after all. I'm sorry, but I have decided to turn traitor. I have a plan, and to
achieve it, I must forsake my former name and print counterfeit bills with the help of an accomplice. The gold coins we've recovered are being stored in the facility where you all once helped me rescue my sister. I know you may resent me for it, but I believe this choice was
for the best.
So you're saying that all this time Lord Shadow was doing this for us?
This is the world as only he can see it.
He could foresee everything and he chose the best option. We should have known.
He identified the cult's plot before anyone else could figure it out, and then he used it against them. By circulating counterfeit bills before the cult made their move, he was able to collect a tremendous fortune.
Now Mitsugoshi will be able to survive the credit collapse, and the cult no longer has the MCA on their side. They are the only losers in this war.
Well, obviously, the cult tangled with the wrong man because Lord Shadow has a deeper understanding of credit creation than anyone else.
He boldly and efficiently collected funds, all with a full knowledge of the risks of credit collapse. I could learn from this. He hid his identity in order to remove his connection to us, to hide the fact that the counterfeit bills, Mitsugoshi, and Shadow Garden are all tied together.
He built his counterfeit printing operation in a place we're familiar with and marked the location of his vault. And fooling your enemy first to deceive your allies, that's what he was doing!
Now all that's left is for us to collect all the gold.
An elaborate plan based on intricate and advanced calculations. I'd expect nothing less from Lord Shadow.
Once it's all over, then you'll understand. You'll know that this was the best choice. That is exactly as he said it to me.
But then what about Delta?
I wouldn't worry.
Huh?
Delta?
Delta! I was so worried!
Delta went on a hush-hush secret mission and,
We know! Lord Shadow asked you to do something for him!
Delta went to the Black Jugga and... Oh, crap, it's a hush-hush secret mission, so I can't tell you.
Delta, learn how to use words properly. Hush-hush secret is redundant, you understand?
What? But boss said...
Now you know he would never talk like that.
Huh?
But I'm glad to see you're all right.
busy running around beating up all the bad guys who are after my money. I mean, trying to find the secret of the counterfeit bills. But today is one day where it doesn't bother me in the least to be the only man on staff. Because Yukime said she's not doing this for the money. And that means I get to keep all the dough for myself! Yukime will probably be back soon. Now I just need to look down on the city from somewhere up high, mutter something that sounds significant, and this job is done.
The total collapse has begun. It's all going according to plan.
Mr. Smith! Mr. John Smith!
It
We've lost
time
total
to
contact
carry this
with Lady
Yukime.
Unless we're afraid that Kitan has...
Be...
Mr. Smith?
Kitan.
Kitan, huh? Of course, Kitan. Now I see what has happened here.
There's not a single gold coin left.
No, you don't think, Kitan. But wait, it seems a little soon for that.
You've tried to get your grubby hands on something very precious to me, but you will give it back. I'll see to that.
Start talking. Surely you have something to say. have something you want to say?
I have nothing to say to you.
Now talk. Say what it is you need to say already.
I have nothing to say.
Talk. Say what you have to say. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it.
That obscene level of power. It's just like the monster who took the light from my eyes that day, long ago. If I only had that power, maybe something would have been different. I really didn't want to let them take from me. I wanted to protect. I leave you, my precious Yukime. Let me know the snow.
Very well, then. Your treasure is in good hands.
Marketplace, taking offensive action against the royal distribution.
Yukime, we're so glad you're all right.
I'm sorry for worrying you.
Mr. Smith ran out as soon as we told him. Speaking of which, where is he?
I believe he has gone to give a proper burial. He truly is such a compassionate man. But how?
Yukime of the White Tower. My name is Alpha. I am with Shadow Garden. It seems rather apparent that he's not told you of us yet. You were his accomplice in all of this, as well as the love of Gatan's life. This is for you. The major corporate alliance has been destroyed. We were able to recover everything we needed before the royal investigation began. We found that in Gatan's chambers. The writing was difficult to read, but I believe it is addressed to you.
His handwriting is messy, but his poor eyesight is not necessarily the only reason for that. He was never the type of man who could sit comfortably at a desk. For important correspondence, he often dictated to me, and I wrote the letters.
It's to the Cult of Diablos. That is the name of the organization that led Gatan astray.
The Cult of...
They take advantage of a person's weakness, narrow their vision, and lure them to darkness. Shadow Garden is fighting to stop them. He is too, of course.
He?
He goes by the alias John Smith.
So Shadow.
Mitsugoshi is a front company for Shadow Garden. He has been pulling all the strings from the beginning. My apologies, but we collected every one of the gold coins.
So that was the plan all along. And this is how Mitsugoshi will survive the credit collapse, I presume?
We have taken over all of the MCA's outlets. Our position will soon be absolute.
He knew exactly what would happen all along.
If you wish to denounce him as a traitor, you are welcome to do so. He is prepared to accept even that.
I have no such intentions.
We're prepared to welcome you to our ranks, Lady Yukime.
Yes, Mitsugoshi as your front, and me as your underbelly. I expect that's your proposal.
Thank you for joining us.
I look forward to doing business with you.
digging holes constantly ever since, and yet for some reason I haven't found a thing. I was supposed to retrieve the gold coins he entrusted to me and achieve my happy ending. But unfortunately, I haven't found a single gold coin. I'm getting radio silence from Yukime, and Mitsuhoshi continues to be doing just fine.
Boss! When we're done digging holes, then you will do what I say?
Hmm?
You promised, boss.
What? I wouldn't make a promise like that.
You did!
Fine, but I didn't say I would do anything.
Yes, you did!
No, it had to be something I'm capable of.
You said you'd do it!
Delta, you shouldn't lie. I never said that. If I had a voice recorder, everyone would know that you are lying.
Hmm? Voice recorder?
A weapon of the shadows. If it were ever used, it would bring about the end of the world.
Yes!
You don't want the world to end, do you? That's why you shouldn't lie.
I don't want the end of the world, but you did say it, boss!
All right, then we can compromise. I'll do what I can. But you know, Delta, I'm not Santa, so that means I can't give you anything.
Santa?
Santa Claus. An evil, fiendish demon lord clad in red who descends upon the world of shadows.
Demon lord?
His suit is a deep blood red because he betrays people's dreams, grants them despair, and...
Hey, Sid! Sid, dude, wake up!
It's the perfect day for us to pick up the ladies. It's our lucky chance.
With older working women. So come on, Sid, let's go.
Let's go find some ladies.
Huh? What? He's not even here.
And he didn't lock his door. That's careless. And here it's finally our chance to score some dates with the lovely ladies of Mitsugoshi.
Huh? Huh? Mitsugoshi Hot Springs Land?
VIP tickets to the grand opening? These items are so premium, not even the highest ranking nobles can get them!
What could Sid be doing with them? Hold up!
Huh?
Even rich dudes can't get these special tickets, right? So, if we show them to some girls...
The odds of our lady hunt succeeding will go through the roof!
We might even get somewhere with the glamorous girls of Mitsugoshi!
When you date a glamour girl, a high-end resort is just part of the package!
How many are there?
Looks like 6 tickets.
Assuming 3 of them are for girls.
One is for me.
Another is for me.
What about the last one?
An extra one for me.
This is it! Excuse me, lovely lady.
We have VIP tickets to a hot spring resort.
VIP tickets were given out only to a chosen few. How did they happen to come into the possession of young gentlemen such as yourselves? Okay, let's try this again. How did the kind of imbecilic gentlemen who would rave like idiots outside of our establishment come into possession of these VIP tickets, huh?
Honestly, they were gifts!
They were gifts. You didn't steal them or find them on the ground?
Certainly not! I assure you we took them from our friend's room, but our friend Sid let us have them!
Huh?
It's true, good old Sid! He told us to take them and ask the ladies of Mitsugoshi out on a date!
This Sid, are you referring to the young master Sid Kagano?
Yes, that's the guy!
My BFF, old Sid Kagano!
I see.
Excuse me, but do you happen to be acquainted with our friend Sid?
Today can be the day you get to be acquainted with me.
Shut up, that's enough. He took the tickets we arranged for him and gave them to his 2 classmates, calling the numbers to meet. I assume Master Sid Kagano will be present on this date?
Of course he will!
He'll be there, I swear! I know in my heart he will!
I never imagined he would use students from the academy like this to send such a complicated code. What does Lord Shadow truly hope from us? I shall have to seek counsel from the 7 Shadows.
Miss? Excuse me. So, what is your answer about our date?
It is a very appealing offer. I will take it into serious consideration.
So quit running your mouth and sit still, you pathetic little worm!
I understand. He
his tickets to his classmates and invited Shadow Garden's numbers. So he must have some purpose in mind to use the tactic of a group date to invite me. To invite us to join him at Mitsugoshi Hot Springs Land.
If I may, what exactly is Mitsugoshi Hot Springs Land?
Ada?
Yeah?
You designed Hot Springs Land, so...
Mitsugoshi Hot Springs Land is a relaxation resort complex set to open this coming week. With a theme based around the legend of the Dragon's Tears, this groundbreaking...
Don't read the description straight off the brochure.
Legend of the Dragon's Tears?
Yes, it was something Lord Shadow told us on that fateful day.
I remember that.
Playtime is over.
We finished over here, too. All cleaned up now.
You cannot have them. You will never have the dragon's tears. Those golden dragon tears.
What is the matter, Shadow?
Is something wrong,
perhaps?
Or...
Do you know the dragon's tears?
I've certainly heard of it. I believe there was a reference to something like that in this region's folklore.
A legend that has slumbered since ancient times. Now, dig up the entire region.
What do you mean?
Surely you can see it. The dazzling radiance that fills this land. The golden tears raining down from the heavens. Now, dig.
3 days later, he left the region in a terrible hurry. Surely he was off on a crucial mission that only he was capable of accomplishing. It's always like that with him. He always goes on ahead, leaving the rest of us behind. But if that is his choice, then we will do our best to abide by it. If he has unfinished business here, then we will finish it in his place. But I wonder what we could possibly find here. I found something.
What happened?
Yeah, that seems right to me.
I think you doubled up on too many roles.
When all was said and done, all we managed to do was build the Hot Springs Land, but surely he had more in mind than simply to soak in a hot spring.
Lord Shadow did seem to be interested in the legend of the Dragon Tears,
but we didn't sense any dragon magic in the area. Maybe the dragon was a metaphor that has to do with the cult.
I believe we've already eliminated all cult activity.
With the data we currently have, it's impossible to know for sure.
Yes, that is true. However, I am certain we will find out more if we go on this hot springs date with him. We gave him a total of 6 tickets. With his 2 little school friends, that brings Lord Shadow's party to 3.
Then it would seem reasonable to match him 3 for 3.
3 of us.
But the question is, which 3 of us will go?
Delta will be one to go to the hot springs with the bus!
Since they asked me personally, I should... You can't go on this mission. You have business to attend to. Isn't that right?
No, so immature.
I know what it is.
Yes,
it's power pressure from the wisdom of the shadows. This mission will not be possible for any but the 7 shadows. So I will personally...
Just a minute, please. It's important we consider the operative's ability to adapt to public society.
We should send someone who knows the area.
Surely this will require someone with the ability to manage a budget.
Considering the length of the mission, I believe it calls for someone with superior control of her magic.
I would suggest that we need someone who has the resourcefulness to adapt to any change in the situation.
Delta is going to the hot spring with the bus!
It would appear that we have no other choice.
Words are useless to us now.
There's no need to hold back.
There are 3 positions to fill,
which means 3 victors.
Delta is going to the hot spring with the boss!
Let us begin.
Rock, paper, scissors!
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
It's so nice to meet you. I'm Skeletal.
And I'm Potato.
I'm Natsume.
Huh?
I'm Zaytan.
Huh?
That's Deltan.
I hear Miss Rainu had some urgent business.
But each of you is every bit as beautiful as...
Excuse me, but you seem to be missing someone.
I can't believe I'm in
that Mr. Sid Cogno is with you. Where's your friend?
Sid, he had to cancel.
No, he didn't. He's running late. That's it. He'll be here later.
Running late? And he will be here?
Yes, I'm certain he will.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Hopefully.
Oh, is that all it is?
If that's the case, you should have just said something before. All right, then. I think we should all get in the water.
Let's go, Mutt.
Delta isn't a dog.
Is it me, or was that really awkward?
This is bad, Skill. An ironclad rule in dating is to have equal numbers of boys and girls. Now one of them will be stuck as a fifth wheel.
Is that the problem? Damn it all. Why is there only one of me?
For now, we'll just buy time by sticking with the story that Sid is coming later.
Right. In the meantime, we will obtain our victory.
Yes, with our secret weapon. This book by Count Virgin Boy. World's Best Love Tips. Your heart-pounding first hot springs date edition.
Yeah! Count Virgin Boy. He's the legendary pickup artist who has practiced the art 28,000 times in the course of his life. And at age 30, he earned himself the honorable title of wizard. We can do this! Today is the day
that we become men.
Then Shadow really isn't here.
According to his schoolmates, apparently not.
Delta doesn't smell the boss's scent anywhere.
I have to do better. The last two times, all I did was cause Lord Shadow more trouble. I have to accomplish something this time. My tummy hurts.
That's because you snack too much.
Be honest, you're relieved that Lord Shadow isn't here to see how flabby and unhealthy you've gotten.
I am not flabby!
But the possibility still remains that he may not show up at all.
Yes, I would believe he has entrusted this mission entirely to us.
Oh no!
Of course, it's also possible he will come, which is why we all must be prepared. Do you understand?
She's awfully enthusiastic. She didn't come out looking very good after this last incident.
I won't be outdone.
What is that?
My newest invention. You can use magic to change its color at will. You can even make it see-through.
Wait, see-through?
No, see-through is not allowed. In a string bikini?
Nothing too provocative.
But you're wearing...
You heard me.
Shadow's mission. What if this was what he wanted all along?
What?
We have been battling continually, never taking a minute to rest. To save the world, we had no choice. But it means we've constantly been on our guard, with no time for mental or emotional relaxation. I wonder if he gave us this respite out of consideration for our well-being.
Would Lord Shadow do that?
I'm just speculating. Thinking about the possibilities. Whatever he is thinking is always above my ability to comprehend.
Oh. So do you foresee any problems?
Other than you using her paid time off at just the wrong time, no, I don't see a problem.
I do.
Huh? Ada!
I just picked up an abnormal magical signature deep underground.
You know, I don't remember anything after they asked me to play volleyball.
I don't even know the first thing about how I got to be lying here like this.
Where are the girls, anyway?
They all went to the girls' bath together.
The girls' bath? Thought this place had mixed bathing.
Mitsugoshi Hot Springs Land caters to any and all of its customers' needs, and offers everything, including private family baths, children's baths, and gender-segregated swimsuit-free baths.
You know your baths. Hang on. We came here on a date and they went to the girls' bath? Does that mean the ladies are avoiding us?
Just the opposite. See, according to Count Virgin Boy's book, when girls leave the table at a group date, it's to discuss which girl gets which boy so there's no overlap. So really, if you think about it, this is good news, so don't worry. And one other thing.
What?
According to Count Virgin Boy, since ancient times when men and women are divided at a hot spring, there is a tradition that must be upheld.
Wait, you don't mean...
Yes, I do mean...
You don't think we're... There's no doubt in my mind.
We're just playing around! I have to do something. If I don't, it'll just be another mission where I was nothing but a delicate elven princess.
That's your problem, you know.
You couldn't help it. Treasure hunting is really hard work. And you guys aren't Delta, so it's just too much for you.
That stupid mutt's babbling aside, I think we're going to have to rethink what our Lord's objective really is.
What exactly do you mean?
What I keep coming back to is the dragon's tears.
The dragon's tears.
Once upon a time, there lived in this land a kind and gentle princess. One day, the princess rescued a small dragon that had been separated from its clutch. The princess and the dragon became fast friends, and they grew up together. But their days of peace and happiness eventually came to an end. Because war had broken out. The dragon fought to protect the princess, fending off 100,000 soldiers despite being afflicted with deep wounds. But when the dragon returned to find the princess, all that remained was the royal capital in ruins. Just as the princess was about to take her last breath, the dragon said to her, "Your Highness, please open your eyes. Let us soar through the skies once more." Just then, the dragon noticed a single tear fall from the princess's lifeless form. "Please, Your Highness, don't cry." The dragon in turn began to weep uncontrollably. Hot tears flooded the land, covering the entire kingdom. The princess awoke to find a mysterious spring of warm water, filled with the essence of life. But the dragon was nowhere to be seen. The princess called the dragon's name. Her voice merely echoed throughout the uninhabited sky.
It may be that what our Lord truly seeks is hidden somewhere inside this tale.
That was a pretty good performance, Lambda. So you think we should be focusing on the water?
Well, according to all our research, it's just a normal hot spring.
Do you see anything yet?
Hold still, almost there! We can't use any magic or they're gonna catch us!
But we still have our white-hot friendship, right?
Well, according to Count Virgin Boy...
The bold men
get the ladies!
We may not be able to do it alone.
But together, we can put an end to the curse of...
our virginity!
Nothing is impossible for the wisdom of the shadows.
Is everything okay?
I detected that magic again. This way. The hot spring is reacting to tears, I think.
If I remember correctly, we did pull the water for this hot spring from underground.
Reaction isn't stronger.
That's going a bit too far. They are technically Lord Shadow's schoolmates, you know.
And the underground readings.
I don't know what significance the underground has, but if we're talking about tears, in the legend, it was the princess's tears.
Huh? Self-proclaimed delicate elven princess.
So what if I am?
The wisdom of the shadows always requires a sacrifice.
Now that is a princess in distress, for sure.
Stop being clever and help me, please!
Now then.
What is that?
An artifact that you insert into the rear end to improve bowel function.
What are you doing? Wait, how is that an artifact?
Its side effects include excessive leakage from every orifice in the body.
I don't want to do this!
That's the trouble with airheads whose nourishment only goes to their chest. Do you mind if I remodeled you until you're nothing but an old rag? The master even said, "I despise pygmies." I mean, I think he did. Probably. As a matter of fact, he said he's fed up with...
with silver hair.
Is that a part of the wisdom of the shadows?
Yes. It's the drill sergeant method of training new recruits by putting them down constantly until they are devoid of all self-esteem and they do what you want.
Huh. I feel like she really means it too, though.
Why? How can you say such terrible things like that to me? I'm trying! I swear I really am! Just as hard as the rest of you!
It's magic!
Shadow was trying to tell us?
Lady Alpha, if we don't do something, it will damage the facility.
We can't just stand here. Let's go, everyone!
Right!
Colors?
We can't let the public know that we are Shadow Garden.
Look out, Delta's going in first!
Me too!
Golden tears are raining down from the heavens.
This is it. This is what our Lord was looking for. No doubt about it. The hot springs have been imbued with magical properties.
A new business opportunity!
They can now improve beauty, health, plus...
I'm trying just as hard as the rest of them. It's hard being in first place all the time.
Now I understand. Shadow wanted to rescue the soul of that kind and gentle dragon. So then, are you ready to add the last finishing touch?
I hope you enjoyed our special event based on the Dragon's Tears Hot Spring.
Feel free to purchase our new limited edition grand opening merchandise.
Today only, we're offering a special discount if you buy the whole set.
Hey, I actually took today off, so take a calm day. Looks like everything worked.
Yes, and the facility was only lightly damaged.
This is all I have. The soldiers took away a lot of my things. Expensive stuff like coffee. They claim they needed it for the war effort. Have you seen the main street? Our beautiful city streets have been reduced to piles of rubble. You were unlucky to get caught up in all of this, Cid. Of course, I only just opened it in here myself.
After leaving the Midgar Kingdom alone, I just wandered to wherever felt right to me. It gave me a chance to take another look at myself. This trip started as a journey of self-discovery, after all. Until now, in the situations I found myself in, I've done what would take me closest to becoming the Immanence in Shadow. But thinking back, I never really had a clear image of what exactly the Immanence in Shadow should be. When stuff came up, I think I was just happy to do whatever kind of looked Immanence in Shadowy. Should I really keep going in this direction? I feel like something's missing. Am I imagining it? Can things really keep going on like this?
Of course not. What do we do? We can't give up. We must never, ever give up. Here you are.
Don't mind if I do!
Huh?
Hey, wait a minute! That was mine! Ah! Didn't your grandmother ever teach you that you shouldn't take other people's food without permission?
Oh, I'll make you another one right away.
Make mine without first.
I have to do something.
More?
I'm sorry.
Rose, I will.
Castletown. It used to be such a beautiful place, but even this city couldn't escape the fires of war. I felt if I joined Shadow Garden, I could do something to help. If I got stronger, maybe I could save my kingdom from ruin. But I haven't. Oh.
Number 666, it's time. Please hurry.
I'll be right out. Number 559 will be leading the mission today.
Number 559? Isn't she the one who,
That's right. She's the eminent fighter who beat number 89 and won the right to challenge other numbers.
Eminent?
If there's something on your mind, talk to us about it.
Never mind. It's nothing. Okay. I'd like three with sauce, please.
Is that all you think about?
Now, remember, this is sightseeing time.
It's not sightseeing, it's recon. We're working!
The castle doesn't look all that beat up, really.
But the main street looked like it was hit by a huge storm.
You're here.
Number 559.
You know the mission guidelines?
Only in regards to Fort First.
Come. The stronghold fell to the Perv faction 2 days ago. It's just a small castle town that should be of little importance. However, the cult secretly deployed their most elite force, the Children of Diablos, to take it. There is something here. Our mission is to find out what the cult is after. Number 666. Do you know why you specifically were chosen for this mission?
Because I am familiar with Fort First.
The royal family uses this stronghold as a summer resort. Isn't that right?
Yes.
But that is not the only reason. I requested for you intentionally, Rose Oriana. You received your powers directly from Lord Shadow himself.
Really? What an honor!
I did. Is that not true for the two of you?
No, it's not. We came here under the guidance of the Seven Shadows.
Not just us. I think that's true for pretty much everyone in Shadow Garden. The only ones in the organization who got power straight from Lord Shadow are the Seven Shadows. And me.
Oh?
You see, I too was granted power by Lord Shadow himself.
You?
Aside from the Seven Shadows, you and I are the only exceptions. But you are weak. I am Lord Shadow's loyal servant. I will eliminate any who are not worthy of his greatness. They're on the move.
It looks like there's an awful lot of them.
What lies down that path?
It leads to some ruins. They say it was a memorial to the warriors who fought against the demon Diablos. But now it's used as an outdoor music hall.
Ruins.
Kuadoi the Gale!
He's one of the leaders of the cult, and his entire entourage is First Children.
Preparations are complete. Ah, finally.
Wait a minute, that card!
Come along, Your Royal Majesty.
Mother? No, wait! Why is she? She's your mother? That means...
She's the Queen of Oriana, the one who
slept... Shush!
Now, place your hand on the glyph. Is the key. This is the Ring of Legend, protected by the hero Freya.
Prepare for combat.
But I thought this was a recon mission.
That ring is the key. We will eradicate them and retrieve it.
Key? What do you mean?
You don't need to know that. All you need to know is that it is crucial we retrieve it.
Wait, please! My mother is down there!
Why does that matter?
Who the hell are you?
It's execution time.
What's going on? Why my mother? stolen. Rose, is that really you?
Why are you attacking my mother?
I said you don't need to know.
You people are from Shadow Garden, aren't you? I'm impressed that you were able to find our location, but you start your attack with a falling out among friends. And as an added bonus, you even brought us the missing Princess Rose.
Oh, Rose! I'm so scared, I'm terrified. Oh, Rose, help me! Help me! You have to save me, Rose!
Careful, number 666.
It's Howard the Cyclone and Alfred the Headwind.
I knew you weren't worthy to serve our Lord and Master.
Protect me, I'm so scared.
So now you will both die tonight.
The team we sent to investigate Fort First has engaged in battle.
I see. Number 559 does seem to occasionally have trouble restraining herself.
Yes, and number 666, Princess Rose, unfortunately saw her mother with the cult.
And Perv Asshat?
Absent.
Naturally. As was the Knight Beyond Men?
Yes, ma'am.
Was it all a trap, I wonder?
Well, there were the ruins, the hero's blood, and quite a heavy deployment of First Children. It was far from being a subtle encounter.
We've been constantly interfering with their ruin robberies for a long time now, but he still hasn't shown himself. He must be a very patient man, unfortunately. This Knight Beyond Men, this Mordred, the Knight Seed of Rounds.
Then I suppose it comes as no surprise that he's been able to control the Orianna Kingdom from the shadows for so long. But that patience of his doesn't appear to have extended to his pawns.
Perv Asshat does seem to be growing quite restless.
He has expended a large number of pawns in order to investigate the ruins and to keep us in check. Now that he's having to deal with civil unrest, security around the Orianna capital has lightened considerably. It's a good time to send in a large number of reinforcements.
Have Lambda organize the troops quickly.
Right away.
As for Princess Rose, we'll let the cult have her.
Very well. But this will increase the likelihood that Perv Asshat and his puppet master Mordred will make their move.
Indeed. And that would work out very nicely for us as well, I think. With Princess Rose on stage with us and the cult, everything was set in motion. Lord Shadow is quite persuasive. Clearly, it was the will of our Lord to lead the princess up to this point. You could even say that he is the one who set up the board. Which makes me wonder, how does he envision the end of this game?
Apparently, the Orianna Kingdom has no one available to inherit the throne. And there's a conflict between the newly formed pro-Perv faction and the anti-Perv old regime faction. Factual disputes, war, every man's dream. Surely there's somewhere in all that where an Eminence in Shadow can step in and look really cool. There has to be.
Here you are. I'll get your breakfast right away.
So they haven't crowned a new ruler yet. Maybe I should get in there and help out with that.
Thank you for offering, Cid. But I think I'll be fine without any help.
The Orianna Kingdom is rocked by factional disputes after the death of its king. The strife is quelled by a new ruler, guided to victory by a mysterious personage. An unidentified eminence who lurks in the shadows of history. I like it. I like it a lot. That's what we call a fixer move. If Orianna needs a new ruler, then Rose seems like the perfect candidate. Come to think of it, why did she murder her father anyway? Was she that unhappy at the idea of being betrothed to that pervert? Nah, that can't be it. When she looked at me back then, those were the eyes of someone who was prepared to do anything.
Hey, Cid, would you keep believing in me, no matter what happens?
The resolve to kill her own father if that's what it took to be queen. The determination to walk the path of carnage to become a supreme tyrant. Who am I not to believe in that? As a background character, and as the Eminence in Shadow, I will help Rose become the next monarch. And after she's become the mighty tyrant, Rose will eventually stand before the heroes blocking their way. But someone will step in between them. The tyrant's former benefactor, the Eminence in Shadow. And what's more, they were once bosom buddies who spoke of their dreams together. Ah, yes, it is delectable.
Okay, I get it. I'll get you another one.
Now that that's worked out, I better get ready to...
Huh?
Collection time, little lady! As good citizens of this town, it's our duty to support the government and militia. So tell me where you're hiding your safe.
You can't! You took everything I had just the other day!
Looks like there's still plenty left to me!
I need that to cover my expenses!
Oh, hey!
Hey, you can donate this.
This looks like a good time to go back to my room.
I have left. Yep.
Shut your pretty lips. You know I wouldn't mind if you wanted to pay with your body.
Hold on. Make sure you leave some for me.
Stop. Leave Miss Mary alone. Please, don't hurt her.
Hilarious!
Ah, the wildest of youth. Let's take this money and grab a fight.
Sid, you shouldn't be so reckless.
I'm sorry. It got away. And with all your money, too.
I'll be all right, don't worry. I was once a prostitute in the Lawless City. I had to deal with violent customers on a daily basis. I came so close to giving up so many times. But I could never bring myself to do it. I'm sure that's why I got help. From him. And now you rescued me too.
Well, I'm leaving now.
Are you sure? Maybe you should wait until you've healed.
There's something I need to do, but never mind that. Let me pay you.
I wouldn't hear of it. I owe you for saving my life.
Are you sure? Well, see you later. Bye.
Goodbye. I hope I see you again.
They make a stylish entrance, show off their power, and make a dashing exit. I don't know who that was, but some people just get it. I can't let them outdo me. Why do I feel like I'm getting nowhere? Over the last few days, I've tried so many things to get a foothold towards making the birth of Tyrant Rose a thing, but I started by sneaking into a correctional facility. Savoring the life of a prisoner, something I'd always wanted to try, I observed the intrigue swirling around the prison with all its thrills and suspense. Then we made a spectacular jailbreak. Then I went straight into joining the volunteer army. They said we couldn't possibly lose, but we barely got out with our lives. It was a good opportunity to recreate one of the legends told through Oriana's history, so I helped out from the shadows. But I guess I went a little overboard. Because in the end, a bunch of old dudes I'd never met ended up with all the glory. That's not how it's supposed to go. A fixer is supposed to, like, stand out by not standing out when standing out, you know?
I knew we were right to pick this side.
Yeah, I heard they're losing ground on the Western Front. And some garbage about the legend coming back to life.
Speaking of the legend, I heard something like that happened around these parts, too.
Yeah, apparently they found an enormous treasure in the ruins on the other side of the mountains.
Treasure?
Don't even think about it. Ignorance is bliss. The higher-ups have been acting really weird these last few days. If we want to get out of this alive, it's about time we get while the getting's good. That reminds me. On our way out, why don't we pick up a few women as souvenirs? How about that girl at the inn? Huh? Who the hell are you?
When you want something, take it, even if you have to kill for it.
Don't you just love the rules of Lawless City?
I know I do. Basically, it means the strongest guy is always right. So, I guess that means that I'm right.
It's hopeless. Forget about this month's rent. I can't even stock up for tomorrow. What to do? I wish I had swallowed my pride and asked Sid to pay up. After all I've been through, I'm going to have to sell this again.
I see. Even your magic power can't last forever. You had to make this so difficult. Try to cheer up. I won't merely kill you. I will torture you to death along with every member of your team. I'll start with an arm or a leg. Despite it all, I am grateful. After all, now I've obtained the key and Rose Oriana. With that, I can climb above Perv Asshat and be the next Knight of Rounds.
It's you. You have come to save my life again.
Impossible! Her arm! She grew another one!
And it is all thanks to my master. It's his power! Lord Shadow, you're truly the gleaming ray of moonlight that pierces the darkness. I wish you would take me into you.
He healed me. Nothing short of a miracle. But hold on. What is our Lord and Master doing here?
Oh, Lord Shadow, it's good to see you.
Is the treasure... the ruins through here?
I'm afraid I must report. It's about the traitor, number 666.
Number 666?
That woman has betrayed Shadow Garden.
Is that an employee ID number?
She is not worthy of you, Lord Shadow. Please, give me the order to eliminate...
No, wait! Hold on! Rose was merely trying to save her mother!
And as a result, the key was stolen. She committed a
Did
serious crime.
Did someone steal some Michigoshi Company secrets or something?
Death?
What is your problem? You keep going off about this key. Do you need it so badly that we have to stomp all over our friend's feelings?
You do not need to know.
I think I've had my fill of corporations and betrayal for quite a while now.
Filthy? What is wrong with you? You've been trying to pick a fight this whole mission.
I don't remember giving you grunts permission to whine.
I've had enough of your freaking mouth!
Marriage?
Huh? Lord Shadow?
Rose is getting married? That's absurd. Makes no sense. Then why did she ever? What was it for? I will never allow it! Rose Oriana, your betrayal has not gone unnoticed! You will be punished! You'll pay!
Why?
I knew I could count on you, Lord Shadow!
Wait a minute! May it all be according to your will.
No. Number 666!
Rose, why did you kill your father? Was it not so you could be the supreme tyrant? You're giving up now? And getting married? It is the existence of light that makes Shadow shine so brightly. If my eminence in Shadow Shtick is ever going to get anywhere, I need her to be the next ruler! I'm coming, Rose Oriana!
Here means that this is all the reinforcements we have?
There's more. I'm going back in a bit to organize the next batch. But there was something I wanted to confirm with the people on site first.
And that is?
Number 666.
What about Princess Rose Oriana?
I heard that she betrayed us and joined up with the enemy.
It was a perfect storm of unfavorable conditions. It may be a little harsh to call what she did betrayal, don't you think?
Maybe. But the fact remains that her insubordination put her teammates in danger. You see, I was her instructor. If the organization is to render judgment on her, then the least I can do is carry it out myself.
Unfortunately, that won't be possible. The Seven Shadows no longer have any authority over this matter.
Wait, what are you talking about? You don't mean... Lord Shadow himself?
Lord Shadow has rendered merciless judgment on all who have stood against us. No power or authority can stop him. It is all meaningless before him.
I agree that the princess's behavior was problematic, but that is just way too... Never mind.
There is no one here on Earth that can ever stand up against his magnificent will.
I am without doubt that the princess will meet a most fitting end. Then there's no longer anything any of us can do.
What makes those barbarians think they can throw their weight around here?
If you ask me, it's all because of that father-murdering princess.
Prices have gone up and my mom's cooking is crap. All because of that damn princess.
She really needs to pay.
Rose Oriana, I adamantly oppose your marriage. That's a pretty good line. But appearing in daylight from the sky isn't exactly... This calls for a quick hop over the gate. Now is the time for my Polishikuchi teleportation skills to shine. I'm so honored.
Lord Shadow! I mean, Cid. Oh, Cid, it's good to see you again.
Epsilon, what a coincidence.
I know, right? Are you here about the problem?
Yes, the problem. You arrived at just the right time, Epsilon.
You flatter me. Surely you granted me these powers because you knew you would need them at exactly a time like this. In this country, they respect anyone whose art warrants it, regardless of race or rank. Which is the reason I'm allowed to walk right into the royal palace whenever I want to.
And why I, your number one student, am allowed to accompany you.
I'm so sorry about that. We both know that you, my lord, taught me everything I know about the piano.
Slime content, 99%. She's constantly adjusting it with intricate magic to make it move with her center of gravity, and incorporating chaos theory into this excessively excess-avoidant excess of effort.
Is something on your mind?
I guess I'm thinking about the fruit of all your effort.
Oh, stop. I still have so very much to learn. We have eyes on the target while letting her roam free. Our spies have not been discovered. We're waiting for the right moment.
Well, if it isn't Ms. Sharon.
Duke Pervashat.
Are you scheduled to perform your magnificent talent for us at our luncheon today?
Oh, yes, Your Grace. I'm planning to debut a brand new piece I have composed.
I look forward to hearing it. Every one of your compositions is ahead of its time. It's a joy to listen to them.
I only hope that my music can bring some solace to Princess Rose now that she's lost His Royal Majesty, her father.
I appreciate your concern, but I am sorry to have to inform you. My Rose is not feeling very well today, and is unlikely to attend the luncheon.
Then as her fiancé, you must be very worried about her.
That's all right. It is a husband's duty to support the kingdom in the place of his wife.
Pervashat. Just look at him. He lives his entire life inside the typical evil aristocrat mold. I guess if you can't just naturally master that mold, the road to being a named character must be rough.
Might I ask who this young man is?
My grand, my sublime, my one and only, absolute favorite pupil. Please, let me introduce you.
Your what? You have a student, Miss Sharon?
I didn't know you took apprentices.
We have a secret relationship.
I'm sorry to have to ask this, but does your pupil have a pass to enter the palace?
I thought if I brought him as my guest, there should be no problem.
My deepest apologies, but we've had to change protocol.
Oh dear. Well, in that case, should we come back another day?
No, there will be no need for that. All we need is for this apprentice of yours to play a piece for us. We're all beside ourselves with curiosity over how skilled your apprentice must be.
An abrupt, unreasonable demand. He doesn't even let up on background characters. I like his cookie-cutter villain style. So, I shall respond as the background character who's kinda good at the piano.
Miss Sharon is without doubt the best pianist in the world, and her apprentice may be another genius.
It would be cruel to expect too much of him, but this should be entertaining.
The regular citizens are also jaded and bitter, while the nobility live their best lives in the lap of luxury. But I will make sure that they pay their blood tax.
Short of... sorry, but he's still in the middle of his education. We'll formally introduce him once he's completed his training.
But we're all dying to know more about him. Anyone here would love to be his patron.
It's too soon to consider any of that. He will set foot on the public stage at the appropriate time and in the appropriate place. And when the day arrives, I'm sure the entire world will know his name.
When that happens, I do hope you'll come talk to me.
I will spare no expense in promoting you.
Nor will I.
Let me help.
No, allow me.
Master Sharon.
Oh?
While I'm here, I would like to take a look around and see more of the palace.
Yes, while you're here. This may be an excellent opportunity.
In that case, allow me to show you around.
Oh? I can go by myself.
I could never be so rude to neglect you like that. I insist.
I can go by myself.
I'm Margaret, one of the maids. Nice to meet you. I also happen to be entrusted with the care of Princess Rose, so I know everything there is about this palace.
You care for Rose?
This is your first time here, right? I can show you all of the best places and its little secrets.
Excuse me, miss. Would you kindly stop?
Slime content.
Huh?
0%, huh? It's winter now, isn't it?
There's an artifact buried deep underground that keeps the temperature constant. You know, I have to tell you, I was so touched by your performance earlier. I'm sure you'll be a top-class pianist in no time. That was more wonderful than any piano performance I've heard in my life.
Yeah, because the performance techniques in this world are pretty underdeveloped compared to modern Japan.
I happened to overhear that Earl Patron himself has his eye on you. If you become his personal pianist, you're guaranteed at least 100 million zenny a year!
100 million zenny?! And they do annual salaries here?
Marquis Newwealth spoke very highly of you as well, but he would only pay you 70 million. He has a broad network of connections, so if you're looking for fame, you should go with Marquis Newwealth.
The future musician route, eh? If I get a yearly salary, I won't have to count on handouts for every gig. That might actually work.
And I also recommend my own family.
Your family?
Our starting pay for musicians is 50 million, but I can talk to my father and convince him to give you 70.
You can do that, huh?
Just between you and me, I happen to be on very good terms with both Earl Patron and Marquis Newwealth. Just let me handle everything. I can work it all out perfectly.
Yeah, but Master Sharon probably wouldn't like that.
Lady Sharon only wants to keep her darling little apprentice to herself. Don't worry about it, and just leave it all to me, all right? I will do everything in my power to support you. What?
Come to think of it, you're Princess Rose's maid, aren't you? Where is she right now?
You're interested in Princess Rose, Mr. Apprentice? Personally, I detest that woman. I was her personal maid even before she left to study in Midgar. At first, I liked her because she was different. She was a strange kind of person, really, taking an interest in barbaric arts like fencing. But she was kind, intelligent. Everyone loved our Princess Rose. But our kingdom is in shambles now, and it's her fault.
So, after hearing that, do you still want to know where you can find Princess Rose?
Kinda.
Well, I'm sorry. But that's a secret. You certainly can't expect me to tell you.
Oh, okay.
But, well, maybe just a little hint?
I thought I'd scared her off, but she's showing sympathy now. She's showing vulnerability, too. I know what that is.
Don't tell
anyone. She's trying to convert me to her religion.
Princess Rose has been locked up at the top of the West Tower. It'll be our special secret.
She's definitely Rose's maid. Uses the same proselytizing techniques.
Hey!
Oh.
What are you doing sneaking around here?
Sorry, who are you?
What do you mean? Can't you tell by looking at me? I am a castle guard, of course. Is that too hard for the great musician like yourself to figure out, huh? We Dark Knights get the same crappy treatment as any dumb ordinary soldier, while fancy people like you are sitting pretty. That sucks!
I'm sorry?
Don't you look down on us. We're the ones keeping the kingdom safe, you jerk. You can call us barbarians, but we're risking our lives for you, while you're kicking back and enjoying attention from all the beautiful women in the palace!
I'm sorry.
Don't just stand there grinning like an idiot! Fight me! See if you can defeat the barbaric Dark Knight with that music you're so proud of!
I'm sorry.
You're pathetic! You're shaking in your boots! Musician, my ass! The arts are a load of garbage!
I'm sorry.
Now that you know your place, I expect you to never go near her again! My sweet little Maggie and I are deeply in love, do you understand, candy ass?
I'm sorry, what?
Every single day, we come to this garden to reaffirm our love for each other.
I gaze at her, and my dear Meg Muffin turns to see me. But she's such a bashful little thing. Her cheeks flush red, and she scampers away from me. Isn't it adorable? But that's all either of us really needs. Do you understand? We know how each other feels from a mere meeting of the eyes. Oh my, my Margie Wargie! We haven't spoken a word to each other, but your love is coming through loud and clear, my love!
I know love comes in all shapes and sizes, but the fact that he doesn't see anything questionable in her reactions... I always knew religion was scary.
I'm happy that I was able to protect my mother, but the kingdom is... Shadow Garden is on the move. Now that they think I turned traitor, they won't give me a second thought. Then there's the Cult of Diablos. In the not-too-distant future, my kingdom will be the stage for a clash between the two organizations. But now I'm much more vulnerable.
Without magic, that is not an easy climb.
Sid!
Oh. Hey, Rose.
Oh, Sid! You're here! How I've missed you!
I missed you too, sweet Rose. I had to see you no matter what. There's something I've wanted to tell you.
That's no reason to... But how in the world did you get here?
I snuck in as the apprentice of a pianist friend of mine.
So you risked your life for me?
I wanted to talk to you about your impending marriage.
There's nothing to talk about.
It's not true, is it?
It is true. I am going to marry Duke Perv Asshat.
Lies! Please, you must remember. Think back on that day.
You told me, come with me, you would be a fighter.
Enough! Listen to me. Please don't bring up that day. Don't think about me. Forget I even exist.
Rose, no.
I can't.
We're the same, you and me. Rose, you grew up in a kingdom that looks down on fencers, but decided to be a Dark Knight. Your peers rejected you. No one understood you. You were alone. But you stayed true to your chosen way of life. I'm just like you.
You? Like me?
I have a dream, too, that no one would understand. So I think I know better than anyone how you felt.
Oh, Sid. Your dream... I will understand your dream. Even if the whole world should reject you, I will never.
But the world doesn't see things like we do. Are you stupid, they say. Is something wrong with you, they say. Would you just grow up already, they say.
Well, I don't care what anyone says because your dream is the most precious thing there is, okay?
Rose. We tried to stay true to our chosen ways of life. No matter the obstacles or the rejection, we stay true to ourselves. But right now, you are perverting that way of life.
What do you mean?
You risked it all when you stabbed your fiancé and killed your father. I won't ask you why, because I believe you did it out of your own convictions, to stay true to your chosen way of life. But why, after all that, are you doing something to pervert that way of life now? Marrying the fiancé you once stabbed is tantamount to perverting your way of life. But you've been true to it all this time! So why would you give that up now?
I'm sorry. I have nothing left to tell you. Please forget about me and find your own happiness.
I can't! Rose, I need you!
That is my wish. My one and only wish.
My sources tell me that you had a visitor with you here.
Does it look like I had a visitor?
It seems you've been crying.
Would you kindly refrain from...
Your attitude needs improvement. We will soon be husband and wife.
We'll be married, but in name only.
Mind your tongue, princess. Don't forget that Queen Reyna's life depends on your affability.
Yes, sir.
That's better. Come, we have a wedding to plan.
Yes, sir.
I see what's happening. Guess I'm just going to have to switch to plan B.
Still, I wonder if this was supposed to be the wedding ring or something.
Maybe I shouldn't have taken it from Mr. Pervert.
I believe this is a first for you to fail a mission. I'm sorry. I will dispose of number 666 as soon as possible. Her actions were thoughtless and hasty, but it's too soon to declare her a traitor. What about... Your loyalty is really quite admirable, but it is possible to take it too far. I intend to eventually promote you to a position directly below the Seven Shadows. Do not disappoint me. I understand. In any case, this failure was really not your fault at all. As soon as we knew the truth, we were all responsible for not telling Princess Rose about her mother. We had no idea they would bring Queen Reyna to the first ruins. It was the Seven Shadows' mistake that put the two of them in the same place. You couldn't have known. We never meant to lie to her about it, but we hoped she would never find out. However, Lord Shadow has taken over this case, as you know.
Yes.
In fact, he made contact with her earlier today.
What?
But he did not punish her. Either there's something he's after, he's waiting to see what she does, or maybe it goes even deeper than that. It's simply beyond our understanding. There's a view of the world that only he can see.
It must be a very lonely view.
So we will trust Lord Shadow's judgment in the matter of number 666.
Agreed.
The real problem is the ring they found at the ruins. If we put undue pressure on them, they might use the key. And if the legends are true, the kingdom will.
Is the Black Rose truly that dangerous?
The Orianna Kingdom was once threatened with annihilation. They used the key to wipe out 100,000 Valgotten troops who were attacking the royal capital. This is not just a fairy tale. This time, the power will be used to destroy the Orianna Kingdom. We need to find the exact location of the key.
Ah, that was nice. I like big tubs and I cannot lie. That's my girl, Epsilon. We both know coffee milk is the best thing after a bath.
It is my honor. Please come this way and I'll massage your shoulders.
This brings back memories. I remember when Ada said she was testing a new mechanical massager and she made Beta scream in pain. That was good.
Those were the days when we could be together every day. I hope you can relax and enjoy this precious moment just as if you were back in old times.
Even when he's undercover as an average half-wit student, he's a vision of magnificence.
Oh, yeah. About that thing. It'll be taken care of sooner than we thought.
Hmm? It's your first day undercover and you've made progress?
I have. As far as that goes, it's practically already over.
You handle it so easily.
Yeah, I can knock out something like that with my little finger.
You're amazing, Lord Shadow!
How is your progress, Duke Perv Asshat?
The project is moving along without a single hitch, Sir Mordred.
The Black Rose. If we can take back its power, our authority within the cult will be unshakable. But it seems there are some rats sniffing around. Don't get careless.
No need to worry. The Ring of Succession never leaves my person.
Keep it that way. When the sun rises on our success, then you too will be granted a seat in rounds. But you are not married to the princess yet. Make no mistakes, Perv Asshat.
Sir. Senile fool. The key. The Princess Rose. The kingdom. All of it's right here in my hands. Shadow Garden, show me what you're made of.
Oh, Perv, where are you? Perv?
Honestly, women are so incorrigible.
There you are. I was so...
So to sum up what I learned yesterday, it seems that apparently Rose's hands are tied because Pervert has taken her mother hostage. Frankly, I wonder why she would let that bother her after she's come so far. But I figure I can just chalk it up to Rose's personal aesthetic. The solution is simple. I just have to use my eminence and shadow moves to free the hostage myself. Thus, I will remove her shackles, and we're sure to get one step closer to the birth of Rose, the legendary tyrant.
I was so worried about you yesterday, Mr. Apprentice. After you got lost on my watch, I was so utterly distraught I couldn't sleep a wink last night.
Oh, I see.
And lately, there's been this creepy guard following me around. You can hardly call the castle grounds safe anymore.
Oh, I see.
But
no need for you to worry. That stalker, frightening man, is gone now.
Oh, I see.
He's been formally accused of stealing food. No one saw him do it, but we all know it was him.
No, I see.
I did everything I could for you, Mr. Apprentice. Rest assured, I will protect you and keep you safe. That scary stalker won't bother you. And I'll keep that woman who claims to be your teacher but really wants to crush your talent away.
Who exactly? Who exactly wants to crush whose talent now?
My, my, if it isn't Miss Sharon. I thought you were in the middle of a recital.
We're at intermission. I was worried that someone might be distracting my darling student from his responsibilities.
I assure you, those worries are totally unfounded, because I am here to support Mr. Apprentice in everything that he needs.
Do you really need people to spell things out for you? Perhaps you have flower fields in the brain or something.
My, how
funny. Nature versus nurture. They never get along.
Me?
I guess that's true no matter where you go.
They may be on the verge of war. How can they be so nonchalant?
Yeah, it does seem like the palace dwellers are pretty unconcerned about everything.
The nobility hates violence, but adores the arts. That's how it's always been throughout Oriana's history, because of the Black Rose.
Because of the Black Rose.
We are Black Rose Brotherhood! Black Rose Brotherhood! Black Rose Brotherhood!
Yeah, that was kind of different, wasn't it? Well, I would like to see the real deal.
Huh? Hold on, you want to see it in real life?
Of course. It's here, isn't it?
Well, my lord, you're correct about that, but you see, it's just that it's far too dangerous. However, if we want to totally destroy it, never mind. If that is your choice, Lord Shadow.
That's my Epsilon. I'm just a little curious about seeing the flowers. She makes it sound like the most dramatic thing in the world, and I would really like to see a Black Rose. But finding Queen Rhaena must come first.
They're acting somewhat randy for the middle of the day.
Don't talk like that. We see nothing, hear nothing, and think nothing.
But the kingdom won't last long if this keeps up.
Tell me, darling, why can't we get them to accept our love yet?
Just a little while longer. Once the wedding is over, Rose will disappear.
Be honest. She's the one you want to marry.
You're the only one I love, Cupcake.
You'll kill her as soon as you're done with her and then marry me, won't you?
Of course I will, Pookie Poo.
This is no good at all. It's changed from an isekai fantasy to a daytime soap opera. I have to find a way to course correct back to the 6 p.m. time slot. Course correct. Well, it's a pretty complicated family matter. But if I know Rose, when she finds out the truth, her rage will drive her to a full awakening as the tyrant I know she can be. Yeah.
Here. If you'll excuse me.
Oh, Margaret, wait.
What is it?
Never mind. It's nothing.
If it's nothing, then I'll take my leave.
That girl will never smile at me again. Nonetheless, for the sake of my father, I must try to... I can at least try to save my mother. Please have mercy on me. I'm sorry.
Come. I will show you the truth at last.
The truth?
Oh, Perf. Soon the kingdom will be all ours, won't it, darling?
Yes, Angel. And all thanks to you.
It was worth it to keep drugging that idiot husband of mine. He made such a lovely puppet.
If she hadn't killed him, he could have done more for us.
Rose should have been the first one we killed. We had more work to do because of her.
It can't be.
You needed to say the truth.
No, you're wrong. My mother would never...
You must accept the truth, Princess. The time is right. What did your eyes show you? What do you hold in your hands now? Rise, tyrant. Unleash the blade of rebellion and... You finally have your chance to eliminate the ones who betrayed you. I'm here to help you, but... Well... Yeah. I guess... I'm sorry. Up and raise the banner of rebellion. I think. Probably.
Epsilon.
I would love to scrub your back for you, Lord Shadow.
Her slime body has evolved to the point where you can mistake it for the real thing.
I'm a little embarrassed.
You have nothing to be ashamed of. The consistency and shape are superb. You've done well to reach this level.
I didn't do anything. It just happened naturally.
There was a slightly unexpected development today.
Oh my! I hope everything is all right.
There shouldn't be any problem. I have given her the key. If she pulls herself up, then the banner of rebellion will rise of its own accord and all will go as planned.
The key? You gave it to her? No wonder we couldn't find it.
The battle will be in 3 days. And at the wedding, the sleeping lion will wake. I mean, 3 days should be enough time to process our emotions, right? Admit, I have definitely seen my share of obstacles. I had no trouble using that fool of a woman to make the king my puppet, but that blasted Geerk. How could I have known he would risk his own well-being to tamper with the ring? He transferred ownership of the Ring of Succession from himself to Princess Rose. Sir Mordred told me in order to become the owner of the ring myself, I will need to marry Rose and integrate my blood into the royal line. I cannot deny this is exactly how I'd expect an artifact to behave. But I do loathe that it must work that way. But regardless of the means, the ends will be worth it. For now I too will be part of Rounds! Now I too will be part of Rounds! Part of Rounds! Shit. Oh, what the hell? Where'd it go? Where? What? How in the... Where? I can't find it. Damn it. It's gone. I've lost it.
Perv asshat.
Sir Mordred.
It's time to rejoice, Duke Perv asshat. All of the arrangements have been completed on this end. After the ceremony and you're married to Rose, the 12th seat in Rounds will be yours.
Yes, sir.
I have high hopes for you, the soon-to-be Knight of Rounds.
It's not like I'll need the Ring of Succession right away. I'll come up with some kind of excuse to delay the exchange of rings. Yeah, that's what I'll do.
Myself. I accept everything. My guilt,
my mistakes, all of it. But before it's over, I want to make things right. Duke Perv Asshat, I pronounce you guilty.
You what?
You manipulated my father, the King of Orianna. You defiled the Queen, and you plotted to overthrow the government.
That's nothing but lies. You have no proof of this.
You are correct. I don't have proof. But you know I don't need it.
You think this is a game? I'm holding a hostage. Don't you get it? Be a good little girl and marry me. Then I will.
Said I cannot do that.
You little.
Whatever else may happen, I refuse to give up on true love. I swear it on this ring that he left to me.
Impossible!
What's happening?
Let me see, is this thing on? Is it recording? Father.
But how?
Please forgive your foolish son. I, Geark, will now carry out my final act as king.
It can't be.
Attention, all
is it really Geark?
By the time you hear this confession, I may have already passed on, and I am deeply sorry for my absence. I feel my mind whittling away every day, and soon I will likely have lost all of my senses. But before that happens, I want to tell you the truth. I am losing my mind because I am being drugged. I don't know how. I even asked my wife Raina to assist me by trading out my food with hers, but it didn't help. Nothing helped. But I know who is behind it. It is Duke Perv Asshat. The Kingdom of Orianna is under the control of the enormous organization that backs him.
Surely. Is this being broadcast?
I'm certain, and most likely beyond the capital as well.
That's unfortunate. The insurgents might start looking at us to attack next.
Now what?
I want you to get in touch with Grants and his people. I'll be damned if I'm going to keep sucking up to that nobody.
Even if I personally am defeated, you have nothing to fear. I leave this kingdom to the one I trust more than anyone, my daughter. Rose Orianna will be your new leader. No matter what may happen, I want you to believe in her. She will most certainly lead this country down the right path. My dear Rose, this kingdom and its people are in your hands. Rose, my daughter, I love you.
That's nonsense! You expect us to believe that? That's ridiculous!
Duke Perv is a traitor! Hail Princess Rose!
Give the crown back to its rightful owner!
Let fall the hammer of justice!
You were happy enough to accept favors from me, and now you're ready to throw me to the...
Asshat. As the princess of the Orianna Kingdom, as she who has been entrusted with our nation's future, I, Rose Orianna, pronounce you guilty as charged!
Silence! Guards, what are you doing? Seize this woman!
What is happening? Isn't it Orianna?
Your master, we need to get...
On your key succession ceremony. Now I can finally open the door.
What are you... What?
The possessor of the key and the user of the device do not need to be the same person. All I need is for the signal to reach its destination.
No, not again!
Oh.
It can't be!
This is the truth behind the legend. The monster that wiped out 100,000 Vel'Koltan troops in a single night. Meet the Black Rose. It's time to eliminate all witnesses. That is the indelible law of the cult. Now come forth, Grand Ruler of the Fourth Realm, Ragnarok! Now let the slaughter finally commence! Crush them all! Archfiend Ragnarok! A rose that blooms in the sky. A bat enveloped in flames. A band of light that raises the earth. Each of these things is really quite rare. But they're unsightly.